I've read some of it.
I have briefly skimmed it.
Hello and welcome.
I skimmed it and came to the conclusion that it was a bunch of information about possible heretics and people who just generally don't matter.
Yeah, pretty much.
We're going to Space Detroit.
It's flavor text.
Should we just call it Space Detroit from now on?
Yeah, we're going to Space Detroit.
But that would imply, oh, you know what? Detroit might actually still exist in the 41st millennium.
True.
It's where they got the original conscripts from.
It's almost down.
Okay.
It's the primary Imperial Guard.
You guys have just left training, and you are all acolytes under Inquisitor Bob. Of all freaking names, Bob.
You got something against Inquisitor Bob?
Well, yeah, just remember, his full name is Roberto.
Of course.
No.
No.
Roberto Montenegro.
Roberto Montenegro, Changeling, Mountain Dew, Camacho IV.
That works.
Esquire.
Does Mountain Dew still exist in the 41st century?
I would assume so. It's probably what they pump into the dreadnoughts to keep their their oxygen.
Mountain Dew, the eternal drink of the Emperor.
The boys call it the Zap Juice.
All right.
Other drinks are
space
available.
Space Marine armor runs on Pepsi Cola.
Crystal Pepsi.
No.
All right. You guys, after your training, you have been sent to Scintilla, capital of the Calyx Assessor, waiting for Inquisitor Bob's summons. After being singled out and inducted into the service of the Inquisition, things have not quite gone as you had imagined them. Removed from your past life, you've been tested and measured, questioned and interrogated, but aside from a few lectures given in dark chambers that left you sick to your stomach and a seemingly endless stream of codes and ciphers given you to memorize and destroy, you've been left largely to your own devices, lodging under a false name in an anonymous hablock of Hive Sibellas on Scintilla, the capital planet of the Calyxis sector. You have bided your time for weeks, waiting for the call from your masters and perhaps their verdict. At last, the call has come, and a blank-eyed courier has delivered you a note featuring the cipher of the Holy Ordos. The message within was simple and perfunctionary, containing a time, a date, and a location. The instruction to come prepared and expect company is assigned off with a single epitaph. The Emperor protects. Sorry, epitaph. So, what do you guys think of the summon? How do you react to it?
Well, there's not much we can do.
So, it's to you, it's just a job?
Yep, pretty much.
Yeah. Yep.
If we don't go, they'll execute us as heretics. Seems
pretty
like
much
a good idea to go.
I follow the orders of the Emperor Jesus, Inquisitor saving me from the ship.
I have nothing better to do.
I follow blindly.
Try not to make too much work for me.
Hey, I'm not driving the spaceship.
All right.
Oh god, who was
the pilot? At the appointed hour, you have made your way through the bustling, faceless masses of the administrative quarter to an unmarked service elevator platform set in the rear of a vast and imposing building covered in bas-reliefs of skulls, half-draped urns, and other symbols of death, crowned by an immense statue of a weeping saint. It appears that you are expected. The wizened face of the platform's inbuilt servitor studies you and pronounces pass as you climb on board. As the note implied, you were not the only person called, and you make for an uncomfortable and diverse-looking group standing in tense silence as the crowds throng by. The servitor control chimes active as the last one of you boards the platform, and the elevator descends as a hatchway closes above you, all with a thunderous boom. The platform continues downward for some minutes through maintenance levels deep into the bowels of the government district.
That's never a good place.
You know, when it comes to hive cities, it's pretty much all bowels.
Yeah. I'm just reading the narration. God.
Let him read.
I didn't like the sound of government district.
No.
I love the sound of government district. It makes me feel at home.
Come on, guys. We're on limited time here.
All right.
Okay.
You guys.
If anyone hands me a form, I'm going to shoot him.
Well, screw that grenade. Firebomb. Don't want that paperwork getting past it.
Do you cast magic missile at the darkness?
Don't! No! No! No!
No! No. Oh! Oh!
That's bad. Because the darkness will attack back and will die instantly. Do not attack the darkness, the gazebo, or the grassy knoll.
So is it too dark to actually see right now? Is it currently too dark to see?
No, we have a torch.
No, it's currently not dark. You're deposited at the end of a wide, great corridor lit by lumen globes in the shape of cherubs holding torches. Only the first part of the corridor is lit, and the rest trails off into darkness. As you step off the platform, the glows will illuminate to show your path as you walk forward. More will flicker into life before you, while those behind you extinguish. There is but one path. The corridor is featureless and smells faintly of chemical disinfectant.
I would like chemical disinfectant.
I would like to point out at this time that our illustrious DM does in fact sound like a servitor, and that his voice keeps synthesizing.
Awesome.
It's okay.
That's Operian for you.
He's part cyborg. All right. Don't worry about it.
Actually, he's got kind of an alfalfa thing going on with his hair.
Yeah.
Right.
I said alfalfa, not alpha.
Oh, okay. I thought you stuttered.
No.
Alright, onwards!
Alright. After a 5-minute walk down this long corridor, you guys come upon a metal door, which automatically unseals and unlocks with a hiss of pressurized air, and opens with a loud grinding of heavy gears. Room inside has a jumble of rusty metal crates branded with unintelligible symbols stacked against one wall, while a hospital gurney complete with restraint straps has been left toppled over to one side against the other. The room's most striking feature is a wide mirror which fills the upper half of the opposite wall from the entrance. The mirror will slowly clear to transparency. So I'm not supposed to read that part. And reveals a steel chamber beyond. Inside the chamber, you see a white-faced figure standing in a Medicare robe and a red leather coat draped over their shoulders. Behind them, covered by a mottled gray sheet, is what looks like a body of some sort on a frame raised upright for inspection, while above them in the air, a pair of white enameled skulls encrusted with a variety of brass instruments and long hypo needles hovers expectantly. So what do you guys want to do?
I'm waiting.
Who summoned us?
I pushed Vaughn in first.
Oh. Okay. I thought with the magic one I should probably talk to the figure.
We're all a little bit brusque and murderous, so it should be you, the one who's barely armed. Okay.
Right. I'm going to stand against the wall next to the door.
Why don't you guys all go ahead and make a perception test for me?
All right, what is perception? There it is. Oh dear, this is going to fail horribly.
It's at actually a plus 20, so don't worry.
It is... slash roll 1d100.
Oh god.
I'm sure I passed.
I noticed nothing.
Oh, that went pathetically.
I didn't see anything.
I only notice Varn noticing nothing.
Oh,
what? I'm too busy staring at the sky, I think. Oh no, sorry, I got a good roll.
Okay. Scythia and Mercutio are the only ones who pass the test. The man in the leather coat conceals armored panels in a construction in a that bulge under his arm. Could only be a gun of some sort.
So it's forearm weapon.
That's okay. Subtly get ready to grab my weapon.
Oh dear. Well, he's
the
wealthy.
Both two people should probably come to my aid as I'm sort of staggering towards him.
Diplomacy. Fine. I grab our diplomat and steady him.
I hold Varn's shoulder as well.
He's on the other side of a giant glass wall.
Really?
Oh. No, and
so these things that we should be have backgrounds for, so that we know what's going on.
That would require me to draw them.
How big is the, how wide is the room? Because right now, right now we're just kind of in a circle.
Basically, it's about the size of a warehouse with crates on one side and hospital gurneys on the other.
You do
and
have...
dividing the room in half is this glass wall.
Well, Varn, get to talking.
No one makes lore checks, got it.
What, lore checks? How are we supposed to know that we're supposed to make a lore check?
It's up to you.
What kind of
lore? I'm not supposed to tell you to make them. Any. Like, you could try to identify the skulls.
Ooh, skulls, yes.
Floating around.
Lore, machine cult.
Do you have, okay, so make a common lore tech test at ordinary. So, plus 10.
I don't have any lore.
So yeah, you don't have just any... floating skulls sitting there with needles protruding from every eye socket in everything.
But they're medical servitors. I know this.
Your character doesn't know that.
I'm a tech priest! It's one of those things
I'll
that
make
I
an
should
awareness
know.
Check. Just, you know, so I know what's going on around. Awareness check.
D100.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to do a lore test for common Imperium lore.
Yeah.
You notice even less than I do. Do you even know what kind of room we're in?
I'm not even like... I don't even know I'm in a room right now.
All right. Mercutio fails his test, I think. Let me check. Yeah, he fails his test.
I don't like this random number generator. It keeps giving us good numbers.
It's good if you were playing other games, but
it's
we're playing
we were
Dark
playing
Heresy.
Every other game.
As you guys enter the chamber, the man motions towards you to come closer to the wall, separating you two.
Which wall? I assume. You
can I try and perceive the wall to make sure there's no traps or anything on it, or near it, or on the floor?
It's a giant glass wall.
Yes, wall but there might be something on the floor.
Roll a perception test.
I will roll the same perception test.
We're just not very...
No.
Wow. It's a glass wall. Congratulations.
Glass. Matter of fact,
okay,
me,
well,
it might
I
not
guess...
be glass. It just looks like a wall.
Let's just go look at it. I don't know what this panel is for.
I guess I should probably...
Nope, sorry.
It's big.
He's massive! Oh dear God!
Well, he's a large... There we go.
Alright. After you approach the wall, he starts to talk. As you know, when he starts speaking, you hear the voices come from a grill in the ceiling, most likely a speaker. Go figure, right? Greetings, acolytes. I am Medicate Interrogator Sand, and you are new blood, are you not? What are the additions to our holy war? Well, we shall see. Far be it from me to doubt my better judgments, eh? Sorry. Well, to the matter at hand, I represent the Holy Order of the Imperial Inquisition that we all serve. Our masters have called you here to assist us in the investigation of a matter of interest that has recently unexpectedly come to light. Oh yes, for your information, you are now in the depths of the Temple of Mori, the House of the Dead, where Lords Perfecta Mortem hold court and the fallen and lost of the great city are named and counted. It will not surprise you then to know you are here to view a corpse. I doubt it will be your first, but it is, shall we say, quite singular.
Mercutio is unimpressed.
I'm bored. Let me shoot stuff.
Let us begin.
Here's my character's opinion.
All right. He goes to the sheet and pulls it aside to reveal a desiccated and eviscerated body of an adult human. As he continues to talk, the servo skulls dip and bob out of the sight to reappear with messy-looking organic specimens in test tubes and jars, clutched in dexterous brass calipers, displaying them in turn for the acolyte's edification.
Can I try and perceive
now,
what the...
Now, you kindly attend and pay heed. Yes, space? Go on.
Just perceiving if there was anything different or interesting about what was in the jars.
Make a perception test.
Yeah, I tried that and failed horribly.
You can make another one. You guys tried to perceive the wall, remember?
1d100. Ah!
Definitely a wall.
I succeeded this time.
Alright, what are you guys trying to perceive?
I am attempting to perceive the nature of the wounds and what may have made them.
I'm trying to perceive what is in the jars that the servo skulls are obviously trying to show us.
Servo skulls, that's the term.
I would also like to make the test in order to perceive if there's anything unusual about the corpse itself. Nope.
Okay, Mercutio and Scythia fail horribly and say, hey, it's a corpse.
Mercutio believes that it's still alive.
It's just a guy having a sleep.
One higher than yes, I would have said he thought it was alive.
What are you doing? The bed's still alive. That would have been hilarious.
Why is the emperor pulling bits out of him?
Anyways, as Tiberianus and Kaltos look at the body, there are no visible wounds. In fact, it's not quite clear how this man died.
Any other unusual features? Any other unusual features? Mummification.
Other than he looks like a standard high worker.
Oh. Normal person then. Expendable.
Yes.
Hmm.
Anyways, as he turns, after he pulls off the sheet, he turns around and he starts talking to you again. Now, if you will kindly attend and pay heed, I will take questions afterward. The body has been positively identified as that of Winsall Arbest, male, 23 years of age, hive worker, unskilled laborer, certified, formerly of the Tantalus Indenture, registered habitation chamber 6/23, stack 717, Kaskarla Division, Southern Zone, Hive Sibelius. Subject found dead on mid-Hive transit rail 3 days ago as the car returned to the main depot. Preliminary examination of the scene suggested death by drug overdose. Postmortem performed by the biology forensic, however, revealed certain anomalies that necessitated our involvement. The cause of death was in fact total systemic failure brought on by tissue rejection of implant and synthetic graft organ. Said organ destroyed his central nervous system while attempting to overcome the immune response. In short, the servo skull then, as he says that, the servo skull displays a sample jar containing 10 centimeter long whitish cord of wavy glassy tendrils, still in motion, still alive.
Oh,
this rushed the life out of him from the inside. What's it for? Unknown.
I'm going to make a cryptology test on that, see if I can see what it's about. I have no idea if cryptology is even the correct thing.
Well, that is the answer to the life, universe, and everything. I'm sorry, but that is a failure.
Darn. Oh, well. Oh.
No bonuses for you.
Was it for? Unknown. But my opinion would be, in a word, control. Neural and synaptic override. Perhaps worse. There were other grafts and surgery of a less singular kind also. One leg replaced by a concealed storage cavity, possibly for his use as a courier. Also, one optic nerve removed. Skin flayed from his stomach, I have no idea why. His system awash from alchemic traces, clotting agents, panimmune, and the like. The surgery was expert, but the lesions and tissue stresses, I doubt any care was given to whether or not it was painless. In fact, by the damage to his vocal cords, my guess would be that he probably screamed as long as he was able to. But the little monster is what concerns us. Oh, you don't need to know the gene law or the mission edict, just that it is not only illegal, it is forbidden, it is heresy. Merely tampering with this kind of doc tech is enough to warrant a death sentence from the Holy Ordos, the Arbites of the Mechanicus. And I'm sure you, that as well, I am wondering how such a rare and vile thing ended up wrapped around the spine of some anonymous habrol from the dusty end of the stacks. The man has no prior criminal record. He was rendered invalid by indenture, laid off, if you will, some 60 days ago now, and was reported missing 32 days ago by his sister, one Lily Arbest, resident of the same habstack. More than enough time to get himself in all sorts of trouble, I'm sure you'll agree. These grafts are no more than 8 or 10 days old at most. We have nothing else on him. This is to be a shadow investigation. No open official involvement and no notification of the local authorities. And no one knows he's here either. Korskala's down hive, so a covert approach will draw far less attention than a boot through the door, and be far less likely to kill any of you to kill any leads to our heretic. Find out why and where if you can. Better yet, find out how. Best of all, find out who is responsible. Go with the grace of the God Emperor. Oh, and additional samples would be a blessing if you could procure them.
Can I ask if we can get...
infiltrate, do it quietly, get the job done, and get the hell out.
Oh, dear.
We have
Anyways,
a we're a group of six like... people. I don't think we could really do anything quietly.
Especially
with a pair of guardsmen.
Not with Siberianus' huge tits knocking everything over.
Hey. They are firmly contained within my adeptus mechanicus.
And then everyone else just trying to grab a butt every so often.
Stop that. I'm trying to stay serious. Right.
As you all recall, he did say that now he would answer questions. If you have any questions, now would be the time to ask.
Are there, in fact, any places to stop besides the sister?
He shakes his head and says, none that I can think of.
Does he have any idea what sort of opposition we might be facing?
Heretics.
Other than heretics, no.
Nothing more specific than heretics.
Nothing more specific than heretics.
Would you like us to try and capture...
This guy is extremely informative.
That's why we're here.
Would you like us to capture...
He has no knowledge of street gangs or anything like that in the area? Nothing?
Fine.
There are probably street gangs.
Yeah, heretics. They're all heretics in the eyes of the Inquisition.
I'm surprised the Inquisition hasn't started accusing each other of being heretics.
Who says they haven't?
Are you sure they have?
Can I ask him if we are to try and capture one of the heretics alive so he can answer for his crimes?
Only if they contain biological samples. That would be useful to us.
Okay, can I get a non-lethal weapon to aid in our cause for this? Purely for the Emperor's sake.
That's a good question. It turns around to ask, what did you have in mind?
Like a needle gun, for example. No, sorry, web pistol. Web pistol
straight,
or something.
Straight for the rares.
I'm trying to... Ah, bullets!
Standing army waiting for us.
Let's say bullets, okay.
Might I be able to tune my aspects to read indications of the foreign heretical material?
That's a good question. That would just fall to your standard investigation skills. I will leave the hard work up to you. Be clear, I just want this to be a simple investigation. I want you guys to do the groundwork, and I will do all the lab work.
Just so, as long as I don't have to do the paperwork.
No. We have plenty of other minions in the government to do the paperwork.
Woo.
So could you try
and shoot some stuff?
Can I actually ask him
for to avoid shooting things for a while?
Before you leave, he motions to a crate on the side that looks better, in better condition than the rest of the crates in the warehouse.
Ooh, shiny.
As you open it, it's a kit of additional equipment that he believes you will need for the mission.
Ooh, quality.
Yay, loot.
I performed a tech use tech of 26, and I have a plus 15 bonus to see if I can modify my aspects to scan the foreign material.
And, you mean determine if a implant is heretical or not?
No, to see if I can scan for it.
Can I perform a perception test and determine if there's anything in the crate useful to my character specifically?
No.
Can we have a list of what's in the crate?
I was getting to
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I passed.
Damn it, Kalatos. We're more or less the same character. If it's useful to you, it's useful to me.
That's not...
Let's let our GM continue with the list of what's in the bloody box.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
There are kits for each of you. each marked in separate smaller boxes within the crate itself. Inside, you see the Korskala Pass Token. These coded devices are about the size of a small, thick coin and will allow them legal clearance for entrance to the division and free passage on the transit rail around the Mid-Hive area. There's also a Handvox. Cheap, battered-looking personal communicators that have a private encrypted channel are good for a range of kilometers in the Hive. And he explains that as Send notices you eyeing the boxes, he says, there is some interference in the Hive that may render the boxes useless unless you are at a wire station. So do be careful.
I know what I'm going to be doing next.
There's also Low Hiver's overcoats, one per acolyte as well. These voluminous and somewhat tattered patchwork leather and canvas high-colored overcoats are common, as you may have guessed, to the Low Hiver garb in Sibella's, and will easily fit over anything the acolytes are wearing. So you guys don't have to worry about that. They are also quite tough and will provide you with an additional armor point if you do not have any on your chest already.
Oh.
Okay.
So armor isn't stacking?
Hive mission bonus gear set.
There we go.
I'm no longer naked.
Congratulations, you now have armor.
Wait, who was naked? I'm confused.
Me. You're different, Matt.
Yeah,
it's alright, it was dark, he didn't say.
Barn had no armor set, so now he has one armor damage resistance.
Alright, you also notice in the smaller crates, chem lamps. Small portable lamps that use chemical reaction to provide light, and will operate continuously while their shutters are open. They have a 3-meter radius, and provide 6 meters of directed beam light.
Is there any fuel required for them?
Chemicals that are already inside them?
Yeah, but how long?
They don't have
it. Okay, they're basically glow sticks on steroids.
Okay, so okay. Infinite.
As they will long be glowing after you are dead.
Okay.
Well, so they might have half a day.
Exactly. Yes, giving how long we will live, yeah, that would be hard.
Alright. Next to all these smaller boxes within this crate, you see a coded data slate.
Okay.
You also see a biosample kit.
Ooh, biosample kit. That's useful.
Yep, since he did ask you to grab biosamples. There is also a money pouch containing 120 thrown geld.
Yoink.
Mine.
Each.
Mercutio grabbed it already. He said yoink.
Okay, do you guys want to talk this out?
Well, let's just take our personalized, nodalized...
I quick draw my gun and point it at Fingley.
For the purpose of this RP, I'm going to bump it up to 180 since there's 6 of you and this campaign was meant for 4.
Oh, there's only
one. So just divide that 180 equally and each take 30 thrown.
Cool.
Do we not each get 180?
Hmm? Nope.
No, it's 180 total, so we each get 30.
Oh, okay.
If you divide it.
Yay, 52.
Which we're going to do.
As well,
the hitching clause will go to removing things.
There's two ways we either divide it evenly, or Mercutio gets everything.
We can all just shoot Mercutio and we'll get more money.
Yeah, we could.
As you start...
That would be greedy.
Or we could just...
Enemy.
Share it.
Are you guys dividing up the coins?
We're dividing it up.
Yes. I would say yes.
Okay, make sure you add 30 thrown geld to all of your... to your thingamajig.
Can we take the crate?
The crate is massive.
We cannot take the crate. Okay.
Not reasonably. If you want to push it out, be my guest, but you're not going to get in that elevator. All right. As you start dividing out the money, you notice a loose, a scrap of paper, and on it is written for sundries and bribes. I'm sure if you need more, you can be resourceful.
Oh, we can be resourceful.
See if, curiosity, see if I use call item on a crate like that, would all the contents within the crate be summoned with a crate, or could it just be the crate itself?
I'm sure we can be extremely resourceful, especially if we put Tiberianus on the corner for an hour.
Do you have any idea just how heretical that is?
Yeah. I feel like giving you corruption points for that. Scythia, what did you say?
If I have summon item on the crate, right, and I summon the crate to us... the items within the crate, will they stay within the crate or will they just be dropped?
I assume only the crate would come.
Yeah, I'm assuming the same, but I thought I might as well ask.
I just thought I might as well ask. You would have to meditate on it for an hour.
I know. I'm fairly certain we don't need the crate. We just need what's in the crate, and we're all capable of carrying what's in the crate.
I just... You can never have enough storage.
All right.
So did I get any items from that, or just money?
Is that Drago's keyboard again?
No, that's not mine.
Anyway, mine's a quiet keyboard. Oh, we lost Connor.
I'm lost.
Anyways,
who's Connor, and why was he in our call?
That's a good question.
Never mind.
Whatever. Continuing on, let's get
also,
out of here.
Was there any... each of you in your smaller crate have a Coblast Assay Cognomen. Basically, what? Encrypted metal punch cards that are identity markers. There's one tailored for each acolyte, and they include an enforcer code tag allowing them to carry arms for self-defense. They also signify that the acolytes are bonded agents of the Coblast agent Assay. I can't speak today. That's a Sibelian mercantile operation of somewhat dubious repute, but not in concern with power. Specializing in tech and salvage and manpower services. These are not false identity cards, and Coblast has actually been a secret Inquisition organization for some time.
Who didn't see that coming? I'm just going to put that all under Hive Mission Bonus Gear.
What's this called?
Okay,
do you guys have any questions about any of the gear you gained?
Currently, I only know of the ID card. I don't think I got anything out of the crate.
You got a cognomen, a camble amp, the overcoat, and a handbox, and a pass token.
Yeah. Handbox is going to be useful for a lot of things.
So ID card, cam lamp, overcoat, handbox.
Hand. And a Korskala pass token. It's spelled such. Let me get that.
Right. I'm just gonna do a quick check to see if there's anything.
So Korskala hand token.
What about the
cam lamp?
Bio kit thing.
All right. Mercutio is asking about the bio kit. The satchel carries three small bio storage tubes and a small bio aspects with a range of about a meter or so. Set for human tissue, the indicator on the aspects will flash red and white with increasing volume in the proximity of anomalous tissue. It also comes with a long-bladed razor-edge monoscapel. This one inflicts 1d5 minus 1 plus the wielder's strength bonus and ignores the first two armor points of the target.
I'm thinking the biosample kit should be carried by Tiberianus.
I think we each got one.
No, well, there was only one.
Yes, I should have the biosample kit.
All right, if one of the acolytes makes a mention of the scalpel in the kit, you guys just have to explain what you want to do with the scalpel.
I have the kit, so I'll have the scalpel. What was that? It was, what were the stats on it?
1d6 minus 1.
1d5 minus 1, based on plus strength bonus, and ignore as tool piercing.
Nice.
Shank.
Okay, can I put the
tool piercing? That's awesome.
Is the overcoat actually disguise you as a citizen?
Yeah,
yes,
it lets us blend in and is basically a free one armor to everyone.
Okay, I'm just going to put the coat on the now then.
No, we're all going to put the damn coats on. It's our disguise.
I am wearing my coat already.
Just thought I'd say though.
Yeah.
So, armor stacking.
Yeah, it's only the body and your body. That's it, so.
Alright, I'm just going to utilize my tech use skill in an to make sure that we know how to do things with that nice little bio scanner.
Go ahead and roll.
Oh, yeah. Boy,
yeah,
yeah.
You know how
to
use the bio sample kit.
Nice. Okay.
All right, and you, by studying the bio sample kit and the bio's aspects, you figure out how to make your own implants work with it.
My own.
So your implants can also pick up the readings for it.
Awesome. Stop laughing at the word implants.
Oh.
However, it's not as accurate, so you still have to use the aspects, but your implants can still detect at a more of a larger scale.
And can I adapt the the bio aspects to function with my standard aspect sensor that I have?
Yes.
But that would increase the range, yes?
When it increased the range, it would increase its
accuracy?
Yes, thank you.
All right. Good, good. Excellent.
So rather than having a big blip on the radar, you have a smaller blip. So it's like...
That allows you to pinpoint. Excellent.
Yeah. All right. Don't forget, you guys also have the coded data slate.
Oh, I have a, I have an actual data slate, so I can probably read that. I should probably check.
It's a worn brass-cased data slate. And as you turn it on, you notice it carries basic copies of information found in your briefing, a series of maps and data about Kerskalar, and largely empty files on the RBAS, including pictures of them and addresses taken from the administrative register. The slate also has a basic short-range audio and visual recorder and playback functions. The slate features a 5-key input code, which will be given to you if you need it. If it is accessed without this, its core memory will be wiped. So I'm not going to bother having you guys write down the code. I'm going to assume you already have it.
Well, then I'm immediately going to use it and transfer all the non-get-me-killed information to my own personal data slate.
Okay.
Ta-da. All right, moving on. Was there anything else? Anyone? Anyone? Let's get out of here.
All right.
Yeah, can I ask about my bowlers if I can possibly get any?
Ask about what?
You know, I said that I was asking for non-lethal weaponry.
He points at the coin pouch.
There you go.
Pick up a brick on your way out.
Bash him on the head with a rock, pretty much. Alright.
I've never understood the point of non-lethal weaponry.
That's why you carry a lasgun.
And a lad's pistol. And a pump-action shotgun. Yep. And an axe and three knives.
Yep.
Only three.
That's how we roll.
Alright, now you said that there were lists of addresses. What were those addresses actually for?
Let's see. Basically, members of Arbast.
What is Arbast?
Isn't Arbast the family? You know, this guy and his sister?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, the dead guy and his sister. That's the Arbast.
So you can investigate his apartment or go to his sister, I assume.
Let's go. Let's start with his apartment, which theoretically might be still unoccupied, but given the nature of Hive cities, has probably already rented out to a new possessor.
If he's been missing for 60 days, there's definitely someone else living there now.
He hasn't been missing for 60 days. He was fired 60 days ago.
I'm sorry. He's been missing for 32 days. My bad.
Then again, it's a Hive city, so it's possible nobody actually knows he's missing. Either way, we should start with that.
All right. You guys go ahead and you hop on the tram. Well, by rail car. The journey to Korskala takes several hours. During the time, you guys have no chance to do anything but talk. You guys want to talk among each other?
I'm not going to talk to them, but I am going to work on modifying my Vox to increase its efficiency.
All right, roll a, let's see, int check, and since you're a tech priest, take plus 20. Never mind.
You break it.
You failed to set up what you were doing, but luckily you don't cause any damage.
Excellent. I'll look for it to try again.
To learn more about my teammates in an attempt to create a cohesiveness of the unit.
Start talking.
I just tried to catch up and walk. Sorry.
Mercutio asked you guys a question.
Sorry, I didn't hear.
I was asking you where everyone's from and, you know, basically attempting to create some sort of cohesiveness in this ragtag unit of ours.
The Feral Worlds.
I was Voidborn and the Space Hulk Agamemnon.
So was I. We were on the same ship.
Interesting. So are you two friends? Did you know each other at all?
We knew each other, but it wasn't until after the catastrophic event that caused us to leave the ship. But we really got to know each other.
Oh my.
We were too young to actually
know. I get the feeling you don't really want to talk about the catastrophic event.
Yeah, we were too young to actually know what happened.
We don't know you well enough.
I'm sorry, you must gain more diplomacy points with our faction.
Exactly.
I just go, hi. I'm just like, hi.
Sorry.
Hello.
So, Kaltos, you said you were from a feral world. What type of feral world did you come from?
Jungle.
That must have been hard.
Wait, aren't you two both guardsmen from the same regiment?
It doesn't mean they talked.
Same place.
It doesn't mean we ever actually met each other.
But I...
thousands upon... hundreds of thousands of the Nord guardsmen within a regiment. If not millions.
Yeah. Precisely.
Yeah. Don't underestimate the guardsmen, bitch.
Eyebrow guardsmen raising?
Any other talking? You guys just gonna sit there in silence? Go. I hate these people.
I just ask everyone else their background, as I was asked my background.
Who wants to answer the question first? If anyone.
I look for alcohol.
You're on a rail car. There is no alcohol to be found.
I was.
Yes, so
we can find.
I, Mercutio, was born on a very harsh, frozen world. Quite cold. You had to kill and eat pretty much anything you found there, because there was no vegetables at all. The entire planet was predators.
So would you say it was as cold as ice and you were willing to sacrifice?
I cannot understand how this song has survived 40,000.
Well, I think that's enough horsing around. What do you guys want to do for this mission when we get there? What's the plan?
The plan is to examine the situation, locate anything that may be hidden, and seek evidence of collusion.
My plan is to first leave this room.
That was extremely vague and unhelpful.
My plan personally is to first leave this room.
I'm going to wait for the thinky people to find out stuff and then shoot the bad guys.
That's an admirable plan, but not helpful at the moment.
I think we should kind of leave this room with the glass walls. Just thought to start walking away now. Like, actually get out of the room.
we're on a large tram car now. That's not Varn, that's just a servitor that looks like him. Yes. How long before I can attempt to modify the Voxcaster again?
Since how badly you failed, I'm gonna say not that.
5 years.
Where are we?
We have to be added to the map.
Cough. That's all I hear.
Well, I'm sorry.
Alone in a single car, it is now deserted, but for your group, the rattling carriage breaks into another vast and dilapidated Habivolt.
Habivolt. Interesting. Okay. Where are we? We are on the transit railroad, I assume. So we will be right there.
Indeed.
All right. 10 plus alms home.
Now, if I remember correctly, the addresses said that the deceased and his sister both lived in the same Habstack, correct?
Indeed.
It was Habstack 717, was it not?
Then I propose that we split into two groups. One group goes to his residence, the other goes to the sister's.
I call going to his.
I call the sister's. I call
the sister's. You would.
Have we any leads of where this,
I think since there's two guardsmen, they should split up one guard.
Yes, that actually makes surprisingly a lot of sense. And yes.
Group. So Kaltos, which group do you want to go with? So Kaltos, which group do you want to go with?
Left group. That's what I'm going to go with.
The left group!
He's going to the sisters.
Yeah.
Okay, so Mercutio is going to the dead guys.
Yep.
Okay, I guess I'll go with the dead guys as well, because I think I've got quite high perception.
Yes. That would be Scythia?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going with the sisters. Now, since I've modified
actually,
my aspects
never mind,
to function, is a more accurate version of the biosample aspects, yes?
I'm sorry, repeat that?
I have modified my aspects function as a more accurate version of the bio kit aspects, yes?
Yes.
All right, so I'm going to give the biosample aspects to the not guardsmen in the other group and show them how to use it.
Wow, right, some places are going on here.
Do I get an increased perception for that? Because
who are you giving it to?
I don't know who else is in the group besides the guardsmen.
Who's going
to the sisters?
I'm going to the sisters, I guess.
Okay, stop saying the word I and say the name.
Scythia. Scythia is going the opposite way from Tiber. Or Tiberianus.
Okay.
So Scythia, Varn, and
Kaltos
are going to the sisters.
Mercutio are going to the dead guys.
Okay, I'll give Kaltos. Varn. I will give Varn the aspects since he knows how to use technology in theory.
Okay.
And Varn is going to the sisters because he's the one who talks to people, correct?
Yes, that's
yes.
The theory.
That is exactly logical, and we're going to stick with that. And because I'm showing Varn how to use it, he doesn't have to pass any tests.
Right.
Yeah.
He won't get a penalty when he tries to use it.
Excellent. Onwards
that
to the dead man.
Mercutio, Tiberianus, and Varnaeus that are going to the dead guys.
Varnaeus.
Yep. Yeah.
So an assassin, a guardsman, and a tech priest walk into a dead man's house. The question becomes, is he dead, or does he just not know it yet?
I think you should be a bit more subtle than that and just have, like, one person go to the door.
He's kind of small and frail looking. He's gonna have bodyguards. A bureaucrat in a rundown sector, he's going to have bodyguards.
No, come on. If you're going to look like a citizen, then you might as well try and just go alone. Because I don't think the citizens can have bodyguards running around them all the time.
Would you go anywhere alone in Detroit?
Well, probably not, but still.
There you go.
An Imperial Guardsman's a bit more than just a bodyguard.
Yeah, but they're also everywhere.
You guys are all disguised, remember?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
We're all dressed as...
Don't go in like a group of three going high there.
You're just a group of three hive workers.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, let us proceed. The dead man's house is in Habstack 717, yes?
Actually, can I first...
Yes.
Can we actually go to the enforcer station and try and requisition our enforcer uniform.
Well,
so we can actually go.
He doesn't know you're there, so you would have to steal it.
We're also supposed to avoid the local enforcer authorities.
Steal requisition.
Derp.
No, I think the place you meant was trade markets for non-lethal weaponry.
Yeah. Yeah. Can we drop by the trade markets?
To the trade market, then. Let's go find some non-lethal weaponry.
Sure, let's go to the trade markets.
Yeah, why not?
Okay, before you guys try to wallow the train car, the rail car shudders to a stop, and the doors open onto a wide, raised platform devoid of any passengers except for a single huddled figure dressed in rags. The figure quickly bundles themselves on board, flashing a pass to the door mechanism with unseemly haste, and takes up a seat far from you as far from your group as possible. A moment later, a dull crackling server turn tones. Kaskarla, Southern Railhead. Passengers to Kaskarla to disembark. The conveyance will depart in
I would like to roll a perception test for the person who just ran on board.
Yeah, same
Did
here.
They bump into us and steal our money?
Can I roll an awareness check?
I'm trying the perception as well right now.
He runs on board and we all just stare at him.
I noticed anything odd about the passenger.
I was trying to do it subtly.
Nothing odd you noticed right off the bat to you. He just looks like a simple bum.
Damn, even with a roll of
six. I
want to
run a perception test as well.
So he might just be a simple bum. Let us carry on.
Very well. I disembark the train.
Scum, not. Okay.
Our DM is already frustrated with us. Have we derailed your story too much yet?
Oh,
it could be so much worse.
Never mind. To the market. To the market, Jeeves. Oh, is that a statue of the Emperor I see?
Yes.
All right, genuflect, etc., etc. Local thing. Pay heed to the Emperor, etc.
As you guys step into the area, it's dirty, it's run down. There's servitors attempting to clean, but to no avail. In fact, the servitors themselves are quite filthy, and it's amazing they're still even running. People walk around and
fix one of those servitors.
The servitor brushes you aside and just goes about his work.
I'm fine.
Please.
People walk around in cloaks. You can barely see their faces. In fact, most of them don't even seem like they want to acknowledge anyone else exists. For them, down here, it is a horrible life. But it is the only one they know.
Hmm. So
okay, so you guys want to head to the trade market, yes?
Yes.
Yeah.
Let us keep a watchful eye for those who might be a threat. Without looking like we're watching for people who might be a threat.
Oh.
You're the one who wants to go shopping.
I know.
No, I'm not.
Go ahead and say it out loud. Act in character. You don't have to type it out.
I think he was being out of character.
No, I type for being in character most of the time. Like when I'm saying things like either under my breath or.
Oh.
To peruse booths looking for a non-lethal weapon such as a club or a nightstick or something of that nature.
What's wrong with both that? A club and a bola. I was going to try and find. Ooh.
The fact that I'm hit the blade instead.
Can't I use my Electus to, as a taser?
I don't see why not.
Excellent.
Since it's based on your bioenergy output, I don't know how well that would work. Okay, after a bit of walking, you guys come to a market. In fact, it doesn't seem like there's much here. There's some sundries, not much in terms of weapons other than the crudest of gear. There's one shop that sells bullets, but a quick inspection of the bullets reveals that they are quite useless, except for a handful of them. Mm. You also notice, though, however, these bullets are marked up at quite a significant cost.
Huh.
Of course they are. They're a rarity.
Can I try and have a look around for bolas? Then find out the price of them?
Bolas?
Yeah.
Let's see. You look around for bolas, which, mind you, is just basically two weights attached to a rope. You can
probably make one.
Yeah, I know. But...
And you find a shop that sells basic hunting gear for whatever reason. You don't know why anyone would bother hunting on a hive, except maybe to go down into the depths and kill any scum they may find.
Food.
Food, yes, food. And you don't really notice much in terms of bolas, because those down here tend to kill their targets rather than capture.
Mm-hmm.
After a quick inspection of all the market stalls, you come to the conclusion, if you want to capture someone, you're going to have to do it the old-fashioned way.
Bash them over the head with a rock.
Okay.
All right. Almost to our assignment. How about you just look at the nearby building and see if there's any stones you can pull off? I've got a better idea. Let's just head on to the Habstack.
I have got a staff, so I could probably beat him over the head with that.
I do have a staff.
Oh my.
You had a blunt weapon the entire time.
It's not really a blunt weapon, and I was more looking for one that was ranged.
You noticed, as you guys notice, in the trade markets, you hear there's more people around, bustling, pushing about.
Ah.
Not really bringing any attention to themselves. However, you think that they're locals. Maybe they know something.
Can I...
Who was looking for a ranged weapon?
I wasn't looking for a ranged weapon, but a ranged non-lethal weapon.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
What was that roll for, Tiber?
It was going to be a perception check for anyone just like checking my aspects, seeing if there was anyone around who was...
Well, hopefully, most of your aspects are covered by the cloak. Mm-hmm. The only thing that's even obvious that you're even modified would be that on your head.
Can I try and perceive if there's any black mark for like
go ahead.
Modifications?
Well, that wouldn't be a perception test. That would be a lore test, hive test.
Ah,
I don't... Do you know anything about the hive?
No, don't have any lore for the hive.
Then take a minus 30 to your intelligence test.
Minus 30.
Wow. Mm.
You know nothing, John.
Did you just say you know nothing, Jon Snow?
I try and have a look around and just have an aneurysm instead.
I fix his aneurysm with a swift blow to the back of his head of non-lethal damage. Let's get on to our assigned task.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
Black market ends up creating.
To be honest, as you look around, you notice a couple of thugs, but they don't seem out of place. They just seem like people going around collecting collection money.
Thugs always know something. I wish to shake them down for information.
How about we let the diplomat approach them first, with a group of large, dangerous-looking individuals behind him?
Fine, do it the smart way. Varn, talk to the thugs.
You charge. Right.
Alright. As you approach one of the thugs, you notice his eye is missing and has been actually stitched closed. Or, well, but there's an eye patch covering it.
Ooh.
But
how do we know it's stitched closed?
Eh, who cares? You notice the stitches out of the corner of the eye patch, screw it off.
I'm just gonna do a quick perception check to see if I can tell how recent they are.
Well, the wounds appear quite old, as in several years old.
Not related, then.
Okay. Anyways. This is
awesome, because I rolled a 6.
He's muscular. He's kind of squat, though. He kind of looks out of place next to his friend, who's a bit tall on the lankier side. Why don't you go all over ahead and roll perception test for me?
Another one?
Oh, that was a called perception test on something.
Yeah, that's true.
29.
All right, Kaltos, what's your perception?
I'm looking at my shoes.
Perception.
Pretty sure it's not 40.
28.
All right. Kaltos, you don't notice anything out of the ordinary. Scythia, you notice, hey, the sky, I can't see it down here.
How about what about the two?
Oh, it's just like home. Basically, I'm just like, right, oh, it's like home.
Pass. You notice a small snub revolver underneath this guy's cloak.
I discreetly ready my las pistol under my cloak.
No, that would be an agility check to avoid notice.
Yes, it would.
Oh,
mind you, you're trying to shake him down for information.
And not only that, you don't actually know about it yet.
I noticed.
Yeah, but
Mercutio knows. He saw the pistol.
Yeah, I saw the pistol.
I didn't.
All right.
I did not.
I did as well.
I was too busy looking at the roof.
Tiberianus passed, Varn passed, and I passed.
So the intelligent, the useful people.
Yes.
Don't need any side checks.
Oh.
Varnius didn't even make a check for perception.
I'm checking. Oh.
He knew not to bother.
Oh.
You are the most.
He just doesn't like to be put in the warehouse anymore.
Alongside Cynthia, Varnius, you notice that, hey, there's a rat in the corner humping another rat.
Considering I'm here to explore new worlds,
and this is what they do.
You explore the world of rat.
Classy. just classy. Moving on then.
Okay, so I suppose I better approach these guys and try and strike up some conversation.
Yep.
Try to be.
Which
discreet.
One do you approach?
I'm not helping.
Do you approach the tall, lanky one who's pretty much completely covered by his cloak, or do you approach the one missing an eye?
I'll approach the one missing an eye.
Are you going from the side he can see from, or the side he can't?
I'll approach him where he can see me. I go towards him because obviously he's not as threatening as the other one because he lost an eye. So, you know, he can't be packed in combat. But the other one's still got both his eyes, so you know he probably knows how to keep himself out of trouble.
So he may be the leader then. Sorry.
As you guys, as Varn and company approach, you notice the man reach for his gun, but it's quite obvious what he's doing. I mean, he just had a bunch of people walk up to him. Of course he's going to do something.
Yeah, he's readying himself for defense.
Sensible! I like him already.
I tell him not to do that. We just want to talk.
Roll
the
check.
He slowly lowers his hand off his gun, but he still appears tense. He's like, what do you want? What's your fellowship score?
20.
Also, what are you asking?
I don't know, I stopped to roll, so I did.
You have to ask a question and then roll, so I'm just gonna... What are you asking?
Okay,
I don't know what directions.
Okay. Yeah, I'll ask.
Don't forget, you're inspecting, Saul and Lily.
Who?
Lily is a sister, Saul is the dead man.
Ah, right.
I'll ask him if he can direct us to, where the dead man is.
Living at the past, he did.
Yeah, the person who was previously alive. But is now known to us to be dead.
But not known to him.
Because then I can see if he's trustworthy or not.
He's a guy with a gun shaking people down.
You mind role-playing that out? You mind actually saying what you would say, be in character?
Okay.
Like, how would your character actually phrase this? Because
I think that was pretty accurate to how he would phrase it.
Yeah, that's probably pretty accurate. what's the name of the guy we're trying to find?
Dead guy.
Saul.
No,
Saul's a dead guy.
We're not telling him he's dead.
Lily is his sister.
And he probably doesn't know that he's dead if he does know him.
So, I'll be pushing. Hi there. Sorry to interrupt. I know you're a bit busy today, but do you know where we could find a man called Saul?
Last name.
Last name.
Saul. There's plenty of Sauls around here. In fact, I could direct you to a good lawyer named Saul.
There's lawyers on Hive Worlds?
Where else is the evil going to come from?
You need Arbest is the last name, by the way.
Vance? What's the one of Ugly?
What? You just Vance welched out a little.
Vance is his last name?
What Arbest. What's Saul Arbest.
Arbest, right. God, I'm terrible at this.
Fuchsia puts his head in his hand and shakes his head in dismay. It's hard.
You know, considering you rolled a 33 on your fellowship test, and your fellowship is... what again?
20.
Why does our negotiator have the lowest fellowship score?
Okay, everybody, what are your fellowship scores?
26. 30.
28.
Okay, I've got 31 fellowship. Does anyone have higher than 31?
Yo.
Why is he our diplomat?
He has the ability to charm, but he doesn't use it.
Do you have any bonuses? Do you have any bonuses that would apply to this?
Cute voice plus 5 to all checks.
Does that apply? I meant any skills that would apply to this.
Apparently, he has the skill charm.
I have the skill charm. Language.
Okay. Do you know what charm does off the top of your head, or do I have to look it up?
You'll have to look it up.
All right, I'm gonna go ahead and pull it up then.
Is that a talent or a skill?
That's a good question. Is it skill. Talent or a skill?
It's a skill.
Charm, based on fellowship. The charm skill is used to befriend others. You make charm tests whenever you want to change the minds of individuals or small groups to beg or to seduce. You need not make a charm test every time you talk to an NPC, only when you want to change their opinion of you or convince them to do something for you, such as giving you a tip, a dance, or a kiss. A charm test can affect the number of targets equal to your fellowship bonus, and the targets must be able to see and hear you and understand what you...
Huh.
It doesn't apply to this because you're not trying to change his mind.
Well, we're trying to change his mind into giving us a
trying to get him to do something.
We just have to ask him the right question.
Yeah.
No, we have to ask, wait for him to refuse, and then charm him into changing his mind.
See, exactly. He's now
why don't we actually
goes, yes, officer, that is the right question.
Why don't we actually
me,
why don't we actually ask about sorry. What's but why don't we actually ask about augmentations? Like black market augmentations?
Why are you asking about black market augmentations? Why?
You really want a blunt weapon, don't you?
No, it's just... augmentations, not armaments. Augmentations, not armaments.
I will do it.
Before Space Monkey goes to ask that question, sorry, before Scythia goes to ask that question, he remembers, don't do anything that would destroy your leads.
Oh.
Who are we searching for again? I can't remember names worth a darn.
Saul Argus and Lily. Yes.
All right. Pardon me, but we are trying to track down an old acquaintance of ours by the name of Saul Arbest. We were told that this is the right area, but we've gotten a trifle lost.
Go ahead and roll a fellowship test.
Oh, that's a fail.
Oh my goodness.
Should we play it so that
he just shoots you?
Play it with reversing the reverse numbers? Because we get a lot
Kyushu
of
walks up to the tall, skinny one and asks him if he knows anything about Lily Arbest and where to find her.
I think we need to resolve what happens because I've rolled a 95.
Essentially, what comes out of your mouth is nothing but pure dribble. Literally vomit.
Or we can just
You're
say that my caster...
I'm very honest, was stunned by this man's beauty. That's what happens.
My box caster malfunctioned.
Can I use it?
That's the question.
You
stumble over your words and basically manage to get nowhere. The man spits to the side, his spit black in color. Not that that matters. He must be chewing something. And he basically ignores you.
Wonderful. So much for my attempt to be awesome and move the quest along.
May I ask the tall, skinny one about Lily Arbest now?
Can I first ask, can I try an intelligence test to see what he actually was trying to say?
Fail.
Can I or can I not?
It was incoherent.
Okay.
It was completely incoherent.
I'm starting to think we should reverse the reversed numbers and go for higher is better.
No.
I fail.
We just fail.
I'll try and ask the same question to the short one.
The thugs are.
That's how we fail.
What were you trying to do, Kel?
You start speaking to a local cat.
He had a mini stroke.
This man.
You unintentionally insult his mother.
Yes, you unintentionally insult the man's mother somehow.
Let's just be going. Let's just be going. I don't know why we're rolling checks to.
I vote that we should leave
this. Ask him questions.
you see him put his hand back on his gun. And he's like, maybe you guys should leave.
Yeah.
I suggest we should leave.
This is a lot of good attempts ruined by horrible rolls.
I know, right?
This is mind you, there are other people.
Let's walk away from the thugs.
Let's just get going.
You guys were in a market, and I think market people hear stuff. Hint, hint.
We tried. It went badly.
I mean, like, market stall owners and such.
Yeah, vendors.
Maybe the sundries vendor knows something.
Okay, we'll go talk to the bad food seller.
Okay.
Delicious. Okay.
You approach the cart that sells all these rations. You notice that most of them are corpse starch. Lovely.
Delicious corpse starch.
It's Soylent Green, you fool.
I'm aware also, of that.
Also, to be less conspicuous, can we just send one person?
Yes,
one person to every stall.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone roll.
All right. Who approaches what stall?
I will attempt to approach the racket vendor.
I'll try cleaning.
Subtly suggested to be asked of stuff.
I'll try approaching I would like to try approaching like a clothing merchant. So I can ask the person's size. You know, if there's a tailor or something like that nearby.
What?
Is there a tailor nearby, basically?
It's not really. I just basically sells stitched together rags, secondhand clothes.
Ah, okay.
Nothing to accept.
What are we even trying to find out here?
I don't know.
I'm
trying to find out if anybody knows anything that we might subconsciously reveal about what the hell we're doing.
Yeah, or actually correlate to what the guy's background, I believe.
Seeing as we know where we have to go, I'll just go there and see what happens.
I was trying to say that, and then we were very subtly told that someone around here might have information we need.
Yeah, but...
Tyler, do you want
to
go first?
You don't have to follow my advice.
When you go a hint, it's usually strongly advised to listen to the DM.
You know this person has modified body parts, so who would know about that?
Ooh, that's...
Right, everyone go ahead and roll an awareness test at plus 10.
I fail.
I pass.
I'm aware of nothing.
I just managed to...
I'm aware. I exist.
I can actually see something.
I think therefore I
Okay. Whoever was coughing, are you going to live?
If not, can I have your body parts so that I can sell them on the black market?
He's still coughing. That means he's alive.
Got a toast!
Still coughing?
Are you joking? Are you okay?
Do we need to drive someone over there and perform a high one?
I'm in Canada. I'm not driving anywhere. It's cold. Anyways, back to the to the ration vendor.
Anyways, to those who pass their awareness test, you'll notice there are only two ways out of the Corsicola division: the intermittent transit rail service in which you arrived, and a single exit to the Hive's Arteria network, through which heavy goods, vehicles, and other few battered-looking quad-wheelers pass through.
Okay. I notice nothing.
Can I look around to see if there's any cameras of some kind? Maybe we can get the tech to hack into them? So we can review the what happened? Okay.
Perception with their awareness bonus.
Man, like, ooh, walls!
Can I use awareness to check for any shady?
Can I use an intelligence test to actually see if my character worked that out to then give the information to someone else to see or look around?
This is not going well.
Oh.
There's too many coins.
So well.
you know.
May I mention that you guys suck at being an Inquisition?
I'm trying. It's not my fault. The dice refuse to allow me to be epic.
Can we buy a sniffer dog? Obviously, can't see shit.
Mercia. Mercia, what was his name? I can't. Mercia. Go and threaten someone with laser rifles. Should be far more effective.
I don't think we want to get
draw that
the
much attention.
Local enforcers on our tail, do we?
No.
Waving around las guns is not low profile.
Shotguns.
And everyone in the city is probably armed.
Yeah, we're not ready to have a last stand quite yet. So, how about I approach?
I'm not dying 5 feet into this frickin' mission.
I just want to hold my hand so I know if anything of note is worth discussing, or even bothering to try and speak it.
It
is!
As you ask around the local populace about Saul, they turn around basically saying, well, he worked well. He had a temperament, though, and it seemed to be getting worse. Probably about as... Yeah, you know, with his increasing hardship. I saw him mounting off and drinking for he no little.
I didn't get any of that.
Yep, you kept cutting that.
I just realized there's music.
Did you?
Yeah.
Same.
You rolled too high in your perception test.
I rolled a 28 this time.
So pretty much everyone has the same story. All right, you asking about Saul or Lily?
Saul.
Mostly every worker, or becoming more of a bastard lately. I haven't seen him for about 20 days.
I ain't seen him for a couple of weeks now. Been more than a fortnight for sure.
Do we know where Lily stays?
We know their addresses, yes.
Okay.
The only reason we aren't already there is because we are shuffling about for information.
We don't know what
you
we're
ask
going
any
to
other
we
questions?
It's probably here. I'm okay.
Who's got a higher perception?
Last time
me,
I asked a question, we almost got assaulted.
I have a 24 perception. I'm not very observant.
Yeah, I think mine is like 26 or something. Or, no, 28.
I've got 37 perception.
Okay, can I suggest to you that you look for cameras to then tell the tech priest about them? At the two exits?
Me?
Yeah.
Sure. I look for cameras. Vaughn takes a look around the area, down like alleyways and just in the general vicinity, looks for any sort of signs of monitoring, surveillance.
So is there any?
Is that enough? I don't know.
No, I'm just waiting for Durin. I think he may have had an aneurysm. I hope badly we're doing.
It's mostly the rolls' fault. We come up with a great plan, and then the rolls basically screw us over, and then we're at the loss for what to do next.
Yeah.
Except I'm the opposite around. I get great rolls, but I just can't do anything with them.
You notice they throw Gelt on the ground. You go to pick it up, and upon picking it up, the piano falls on your head.
What? Really?
Oh.
What?
No. I'm pretty sure at this point, if I put my last pistol in my own head and pulled the trigger, I'd roll a 100, and the gun would just not go off.
The gun would dissolve into the warp. Alright, well, we're obviously inept at polling the crowd. So how about we just move on to our pre-assigned destinations?
Oh, appearing. Is that actually, what do you call it? Did that succeed for Varn? Did Varn notice anything? He looked for cameras.
I did say, I guess you guys didn't hear me. You notice a few cameras scattered about, they're battered, some of them don't even appear to be functioning, and they're probably most likely placed there by the local enforcers.
Not functioning cameras, I must attempt to repair one.
No, you
just fixed everything.
Yeah. Can we try and get Tiberianus to try and look through the records? in the past of the recording. Yeah, basically hack into it.
It didn't work very well.
Ah, okay.
Upon further inspection of the camera, you notice that they have no local storage and are in fact wired somewhere else.
Ah. Can we follow the wires?
Another perception test!
It's the 41st century, that's probably wireless.
Yeah, I know. I'd fail anyway.
No power from some. Anyway, the wire leads into the wall. That's all you can tell.
Well, let's just get on with it then, because actually, yeah, let's just try it. Just for the hell of it, let's attempt to access it remotely, utilizing my keen years of training as a tech priest of the Omnisire.
Okay.
I fail. Moving on. Let's go to the house.
Oh.
I can't wait till I update my
God, we're never going to get anywhere in this, are we?
Upon doing this, the camera, you notice a red light on top just blink on.
Does that mean
congratulations?
Can I try
a camera that doesn't work?
Can I try an intelligence test to determine what that means?
Go ahead.
Fail. I'm already gone. I'm walking away.
I'm like, ooh, shiny!
Sorry. Cynthia, your thoughts are something along the lines of, ooh, pretty, must go towards light.
No, I mean it. I'm already on my way to the brother's house. Let's go.
I
failed enough in this area. We have failed enough in this area. Let us proceed to where our original destination is. Unless there's a bar. Where's the bar
no.
that
we can get?
Nope.
Stop it.
Right now.
All
right.
Where you guys want to go is here. Number 8, if you're heading for the brother's house.
Yes.
So we're going to pass by the workers' union?
The workers' union. You heard something about them saying Saul was last seen drinking there.
Oh, the workers' union is the bar.
Yelling at people.
Well, it's on the way. Let's go fail some more in there.
Okay, guys, I'm gonna pass off control of Mercutio to Matt. I got places I gotta go.
Okay.
Okay.
Excellent! Now the DM will be controlling a character, we might actually do something.
Mercutio just became your greatest asset. Use him wisely.
In fact, Mercutio is going to fall down the stairs and break his neck.
Yeah, I had an aneurysm.
Here's the tricky part. There were no stairs.
And he has no neck.
What neck?
Do you guys want to go ahead and just pause this, let the dice, digital dice have a rest? Hopefully when you come back to them in about, say, 3 minutes' time, they work better.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, hello, Cupcop. And Daisy Froster.
Actually going to. This is the... this is rolld20.net.
Oh. Have you stopped streaming?
No, I don't really know. I suppose I should. Back at some point, all you people who are not watching.
I'm trying to think. Can you actually pause an event without stopping it?
Oh, Connor's watching.
Yeah, you can... when you disconnect, you can stop stream... I do not want to stop the broadcast. Yeah.
Right, okay. So, we'll be back in a second. Folks. We'll be right back.
I'm gonna go grab a drink.
Are you sure you want to stop this?
I'm gonna Google whether or not, let's see, rolld20.net less shit dice rolls.
yeah, I don't know how to pause it. You know what, Burrit?
Whatever you're using, what are you using to broadcast?
Oh, right, yeah, open broadcaster, so stop streaming and that, cool.
Yeah.
Let me know when you guys are all ready to continue.
Well, I'm ready.
Ooh, yep. Well, I'm going to the bar first.
Tiber?
Hold on, I'm just waiting for my broadcast to be live again.
It needs to be up to do into two groups.
Mm-hmm. 5 people watching. Are all of those people in the call, or are actually not your viewers?
I'm not watching, so.
No.
Well, I think Paul is
one of the person. Here.
Do 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 do.
You know.
Well, it says it's broadcasting. All right, bum, ba, da, ba, might as well get on with it.
Get on with it.
Bum, ba, da, bum, bum.
All right, you guys were last on your way to the stack number, and you guys decided to stop in by the workers' union on your way there. Yes.
Yep.
Yep, mm-hmm. In the bar.
All right. The Workers' Union Hall is a bar and venue provided by the Tantalus Combine. You remember this from the data slate you were given about the area. Let's see. The establishment has suffered greatly under its current sponsor, the civilian narco gang syndicate. Vandalized, brutalized, and bullet-ridden, the bar is not a welcoming place for the acolytes. Filled with nervous gang blades, morose drinkers, and smashed-up addicts, the only regular clientele are the gang boss Chord.
Hmm,
you're in the bar.
Can we try and perceive for shady characters? Well, actually, never mind. It's in a bar full of shady characters. Why am I even bother asking? Can I try and meet the shadies of characters here? Okay.
Can I roll awareness for any armed combatants in the bar?
I too shall make this check.
I made the test.
What are you guys testing?
We are determining whether or not how many of these people are armed and probably dangerous.
Let's see. Perception test and crowded bar. Let's take that at minus 10.
Can I use...
succeed at a minus 10?
I've got an awareness stat.
Can I use intelligence?
Skill.
It's based on your perception. Sorry.
Yeah. With plus 5. So.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I don't. And I'm certain that evaluate and logic
plus 5,
don't
minus
help.
10, so minus 5 altogether.
Can I use intelligence to determine probably it's
Damn
going
it.
To be dangerous? Sorry.
Shall I try and perceive?
I missed by 1.
Let's just by get one. On with it. We already established that we fail at everything we try.
Yeah, I'm going to retcon it. Almost everyone here is armed with like a knife or something or other just for self-defense. And you notice one guy in a booth on the other side of the bar, he's clearly packing a weapon in plain sight.
Can I see if anyone's twitchy?
It's a hive world, everyone is twitchy.
Oh yeah, true, but so. If anyone's twitchy,
is right. Almost everyone here is on drugs or something.
As in, are they getting ready to attack, though?
I doubt that, they're too high.
Never know, it could be like Flash and Andromeda.
Oh, come on. Better not be like Flash.
Flash!
Oh, Savior right. of the universe!
You guys are now in this bar. It's filled with workers and clientele. What do you do?
The obvious thing when you're in a tavern, talk to the barkeep!
And order a drink.
I wouldn't drink anything they have here if I were you.
No, I really
I
wouldn't.
Said I was gonna drink it.
Just order it.
Go ahead.
That's your money.
Go ahead and roll a fellowship test.
This I shall do. This I shall succeed.
Woo. Alright, I'll go ahead and make a perception test, Tiberianus.
This I shall likely fail. This I have failed.
Anyone else want to make a perception test?
I'll
try one.
I'll try one as well.
Fail.
Yeah.
I'll make one for Mercutio.
Didn't he fall down and break his neck?
Oh, look!
Breaking his neck has improved his power.
Breaking his neck somehow made him more perceptive. It's that new angle of his head. Like at 90 degrees, the rest of his body. This sense is much more acute.
Anyways, you ask this question, and the bartender just nervously looks around, his eyes constantly flittering to one side of the bar. Mercutio notices that he keeps looking over at the man in the corner that is clearly armed. And he pretty much says to Tiberianus, I don't know what you're talking about.
No blasters! We don't want any trouble!
Hmm?
That's essentially it. There ain't no blasters loud in here. No trouble wanted. That's the gist. Yeah, okay.
We don't ask the dodgy guy
who hopefully will attack us and we can vent our frustrations at bad rolling at him.
We don't ask questions.
What?
About venting frustrations. We're probably not going to be able to hit him at point blank range.
And we're probably going to get the whole bar after us. We're probably going to end up getting the whole bar after us, though.
No, that's why he has to attack us first. Then our friendly neighborhood psyker will show up, kill everyone except us by accident. So I'll move outside the building as soon as he attempts to.
So shall we approach this guy with the big gun?
Before you guys do that, everyone go ahead and make a perception test, as well as with awareness, mind you, well as an intelligence test.
Okay, that first one's a perception, okay?
Okay.
That's intelligence.
I failed both.
I fail the intelligence, but I get the perception.
You notice by looking around... You notice by looking around that there seems to be quite a heavy amount of pills, needles, and such. Who knows what they're used for?
Let's try not to step on any, shall we?
Can we... also, sorry.
Let me pick one up in
Mercutio's. Well, he passes an intelligence test.
Can I pick up one of the pills and show him it?
See it, but if he could, he knows what it is.
Can I pick it up and show him it?
He's probably done it before.
He did break his neck and survive. He didn't break his neck. Anyways, do any of you have a medic skill?
Nobody has Medikai. That's why I'm saving all of my experience. You can't get Medikai until, like, the second rank for me and everyone else about the fifth rank.
Mercutio basically casually mutters under his breath. It's like, it's a freaking drug den in here.
Can I ask him if he knows anything about what the drugs could be?
He's going to make an int test, and it's going to be at a severe penalty.
Oh.
He
has an aneurysm.
It's a pill!
It's a donkey!
It's candy!
He immediately eats some.
Collapses in the floor.
He should. With that roll, he probably does think it's candy, and he eats one.
It was on the ground. Let's see if he resists temptation. He resists temptation.
Okay. He barely resists temptation from the look of it.
Oh. Okay. You guys said you wanted to approach the guy in the booth?
Yeah. Hopefully he's the drug dealer. We can kill him and end the entire plight of this world.
Suppose.
You noticed...
Who will be sending you first?
Thing.
Anyways, you notice the man in the corner, and he's like, basically like, what do you fuckers want?
This sounds like a swell time to attempt to change his
opinion of us.
Go, Charles, go!
Ha ha!
Oh, wow. Oh, crap.
You failed to charm him, but luckily, Tiberianus rolls a 2 on his on her attempt to use her feminine wiles. To make him more likely to like
up your shirt?
Appearing. Can I just say that Cynthia is standing near enough so that
he
she can still
for a reason.
Appearing.
Yes.
Can I say that Cynthia is standing in such a way that she can still see the door?
Cynthia, not Cynthia.
Sorry, Cynthia.
How do you keep mispronouncing your own character's name?
I have no idea.
Okay. How did you charm him, Tiberianus?
I have ways.
Pulled his breast, sir.
What did you say to charm him?
Oh. I hadn't thought about that. I thought I was going to fail horribly.
Well, it's better be good, because it really worked.
Yeah, he just showed him a nipple.
It would work. Hi there. We have a problem. We were wondering if you could help us with it.
You sure you didn't just wander over and go, hey, big boy?
Upon laying eyes upon Tiberianus, you see the man, his eyebrows raise, and he seems to lick his lips a little. He likes what he sees.
Everyone likes what they see of the Tiber.
For Tiberianus, you now have plus 20 against fellowship rolls against this guy.
Excellent. Excellent. Now when I fail, it will be even more hilarious.
So he asks you, what can I do for you?
Well, I'm trying to track down an old friend of mine. We lost contact many years back. A man by the name of Saul Arbist. I was told that I could find him somewhere around here. Perhaps you could point him out to me?
He looks around. Not mind making a fellowship test. Sorry. You charmed him, now you have to fill it.
That'll pass.
He's like, yeah, Saul, I know him. He used to talk to Lance a lot, I think. If you want more information about Saul, you should go talk to the boss upstairs.
Oh my. The boss, you say?
That yeah, and he like just simply nods.
And I can talk to.
He simply nods.
Which way?
He points towards the back, just to the side of the bar.
This shall be a thank you very much, followed by a wink.
Why don't you schedule a meeting with the boss?
Falls on her face.
I try to wink, but my mechanical arm pinches my ass.
You have a twitch in your eye. It makes you look intoxicated more than anything else.
Can I
go to wink?
Everybody up the back, up the back.
Can I suggest that we actually try and arrange an appointment?
But you wind up sneezing on the man.
You gotta stop crying. I'm in tears right now.
And as we're going
let's
towards
go.
This,
everyone just go. No discussions. Up there.
As we're heading towards the stairs, can I just take a quick look out to see if anyone has sort of reacted to us moving towards the back?
Yeah.
No one seems to care. It's like it's a common occurrence.
Apparently, attractive tech priests frequent this area. I'm supposed to be cold. You can tell I'm devious.
On we go, I guess.
That must be it. The air is cold. That's why it was a 2.
Okay. You go upstairs and there's a single door up here. Judging by the structure of the building, it's clear that this door leads into a room above the bar.
Really?
Do you want to enter the room?
Let's knock first.
Can I see if there's anything like written on the door?
There's nothing. There's nothing written on the door. I'll tell you that now.
I wonder if the door is fireproof.
And the door is made of wood.
The door is made of wood. Excellent! We can smash it using the head of our neck-broken comrade.
You notice that? So...
I agree we should knock on the
damn door.
Alright, you're gonna bust in
see if it's locked?
No, we're just gonna knock on the door.
I'm just gonna...
Let's just knock! Yeah. Knock on the door! I'll even roll a knock on the door test if you want.
You don't. I went no. Everyone shut up.
It's a strength test.
This is simple on GM.
Can we let the GM talk?
Okay.
Alright. You knock on the door and you just hear a gruff voice come behind it. It's open, you friggin' dunce.
I kind of pierce his throat with my mechanic arm.
You do what now?
Never you my whoa. Nobody needed to see that.
Well, I'm gonna go ahead and walk through the door.
I'm gonna go ahead
I'm just gonna enter.
you end up walking into the door.
Let's just open the door. And go on in. And talk to the boss like the group of fools we are.
So who wants to roll fellowship?
I will.
Okay. You enter the room, and it's cleaner than the rest of the bar. There's a red carpet on the floor, and at the end there's a desk, and behind it sits a kind of chubby man, kind of mean looking, like he's the boss of the operation.
Is it?
And around the room, you...
Is it the kingpin?
Roll a perception test.
I notice nothing.
Oh fuck.
Woo, carpet.
Congratulations. You all know fuck all.
Bart knows fuck nothing.
I got a critical failure on a perception test.
You just go to them. Are you the barkeep? Start dribbling.
I must have taken those pills downstairs or something. Mind.
I'm quite glad that was just a perception check.
Yeah.
On a nonsensical statement.
All right. Also around the room, go ahead and make an awareness test. Mind you, this is at plus 30.
So I got it.
Plus 30. I fail miserably. I'm like, ooh,
I'm
carpet.
I'm going to include my awareness. I make it literally perfectly.
All right. You notice in the room that there's about three guards. There's one standing right next to the guy by the desk. There's one just lounging on the couch. And then there's another standing by the door.
Can we make an awareness check to check how well armed they are?
I fail horribly at that check. So say we all?
I'll try, I guess.
Yeah.
So say we all. We are not even sure that they're actually guns. They may be having holstered bananas.
Okay. I'm going to tell you...
We have bananas on this planet?
Two things.
Shush.
I'm going to tell you two things. One. The guy right by the guy behind the desk is clearly holding a rifle. The guy by the door is clearly armed with a rifle as well. Okay, there's your two things.
Uh-huh.
Do you have any other questions?
What are the odds that we're going to fuck up a roll and get into a bar fight and die right here?
Can I have a perception roll test perception. To see what's on his table? What?
Go.
This is a lot of.
You see scales, pills. It's the normal.
Okay.
Oh, like a pharmacist or something. He's got a set of scales, a load of pills on the table.
Can I use an intelligence test to determine that he's a drug dealer then?
I think that's pretty obvious, but let's go ahead and do it anyway.
It's obvious, you don't need to roll a test.
Okay.
I actually pass because it's obvious and I don't need to roll it.
92.
Let's see, just for fun.
And that's why I'm a guardsman.
You just shoot what says to be shot at.
Shoot at that, okay.
I didn't think we would actually get this far.
What?
Wow.
You didn't think we would get this far?
Wow, such faith in us.
Clearly he has been watching the broadcast as we've been playing. We haven't somehow managed to make the entire hive blow up already with some horrible misroll.
To walk up to an enforcer and shoot him.
Woo!
The entire hive world detonates. emanates in a swarm of warp energy. There you go.
God damn it, space.
Oh. I thought it'd be
okay,
pretty.
Let's go ahead and do that. All right, all of you guys have your tokens in your journals. Actually, I think you should be able to copy paste them.
Tokens and
from the
journals. What?
Oh, I think I can move tokens over.
Ha! I did it. I did it, but we're in a town map, not on an office.
Hold on. I'm fixing it.
Oh, man, we're going to have to add our bars every time.
Are we?
Nope.
I did it too.
All right.
How do you do it?
Not telling. Oh.
Aha.
Oh.
Why is there a second warning? It's here. Go away.
Use special ability, mirror image.
Shouldn't we be starting down like here, roughly?
No, we just came in the door.
I just copy pasted you over.
Okay.
Where is the door?
Where is the door? So like right
here. I'm in down where I am here.
Ah!
I was just about to draw it. I swear. There's the door.
Okay.
I'm behind the door, acting stealthy.
What's the central square here? Is that just the,
It's a table in the middle of the room.
Excellent!
Is there a chair in the, chairs at all?
There's the one the guy's sitting in, there's a couple against the left wall, and there's one on the right, right next to the couch.
Kaltos, get off that!
Kaltos, get off the table. Mercutio, come join us over here.
Cozy. Kaltos is actually on the couch, but okay.
Stop getting cozy with that guy.
We're all thugs here, we can understand each other.
Kaltos.
You want to roll a fellowship test with that?
Are you sure you want to take that chance?
I'll pass.
Oh my goodness.
He just kind of looks at you like, really?
I just barge into a room and you just sit down on the couch next to someone with a hunting rifle. What up?
No, he's not doing that. He's not
Who's
even
drawing
in the room
on the map?
Yet.
Hmm?
Who's drawing on the map?
Not me.
I'm putting the stairs.
Oh.
Okay.
That's good enough.
It's meant to be rough. It doesn't need to be exact. It's not like this is a professional.
I can't help it. I'm an architect.
I passed my friendship test with this thug on the couch with me.
All right. Mercutio stays out in the hall.
What about Kaltos? Because he's apparently passed a fellowship check with the thug on the couch.
Actually, the thug just eyes him like, what the fuck are you doing?
He kind of punches him and tells him to back off.
Alright, are we ready to talk to the guy? Is he ready to talk to us? Because I'm assuming he's going to be like, who the fuck are you? What are you doing here? Et cetera.
He's eyeing you.
I bet.
He's like, yeah, what do you want?
I bet.
Well, he hasn't shot me, so I'm happy.
Oh, he's in the middle of what looks to be weighing something out.
It's alright. I cautiously keep grenades within grip.
No, you don't. Single potentially hostile action. Stop being a guardsman.
You barge into his room, you sit on a couch, and you grab one of your grenades.
Subtle!
Visible to me.
Combat with someone we could probably bribe!
Everyone is completely okay with this, apparently, because he passed a friendship test. Fifth game.
I'll be sure this is what you guys want to do.
No.
Pardon? Get Kalthos back outside with Mercutio.
No, I'm being friendly.
I'll stand here. By the way.
Hi there. The guy downstairs said that we needed to talk to you.
I guess you're here to purchase some merchandise. What do you want?
What merchandise? No, we're just trying to track down an old friend of ours.
Information costs money. I hope you have enough.
He told us that we had to talk to you about Saul Arbest.
He twitches at the name, and he just...
Perception check. I notice it.
Yeah. No, it's a very obvious twitch.
Like,
you all notice it.
Full body shudder.
Yeah. he motions for you to approach closer to the desk.
Sneak.
Also, call. Are you really going to sit there on the couch?
Is there an issue with it?
No, it's just kind of weird.
It's a feral movement. It's okay. Just go with it. Somebody get Scythe in here. Actually, no. Yeah, keep her out there so that she can close off the building from the warp.
Right.
Okay, now you're just being odd.
All right.
This truly is the barrel of bacon.
Okay, I'm back.
No, you're not. You just think you are.
Okay.
So you
approach the desk and he's like, yeah, you sure you want to know that? You sure you don't want some stims, obscura, friendzone? I have any of those drugs you'd want.
I try to avoid the friend zone. It's not a fun place.
He leans back in his chair and he's like, I see. So you're not here for any of these drugs, are you?
No, we were just told by the nice man downstairs to come talk to you about my old friend, Saul.
All right, go ahead and make a awareness check.
I fail.
Both you, Tiberianus, and Varn.
Varn, better pass.
I did worse.
Well, okay. I'm preoccupied with
you. You are just in your own world, Kalthos.
On the thug, that's what you're doing.
Your intention. Devoted to him.
Wait, I passed something. I passed that.
Varnius got a 9. He might spot something. Despite the fact that only
Varnius, you notice him reach his hand under his desk.
I wish.
And it seems like he's pushing a button.
Oh dear.
I wish to.
Right. Oh my god, he's got a trap door.
Move my overcoat and show him that I'm also armed.
No, why?
Wow, in this situation, really?
Just opened a trap door. If you look behind him, if he goes down that trap door,
no, it's not a trap door. He also stands up and he pushes his chair back.
Okay. What is it?
I say we make a strategic.
The gray square behind him is his chair.
Oh.
Varnihos, Scythia and Mercutio all notice the loud thunk from the door.
The door just sealed, didn't it?
Yes.
Bugger, I'm gonna have to smash down the door now.
No, that would take an hour of meditation.
What is it?
I was gonna say, maybe you could summon the door from its housings through the warp.
It doesn't actually say anything about that, though. Because meditation is actually just to remove fatigue, it says.
Scythia, pay attention.
Yeah, I know. I see.
Okay. It's quite clear that some form of alarm has gone off. And you see all the guards ready their weapons. And the guard on the couch eagerly points his at Kalthos.
I pick up grenade.
Vaughn, you might want to try charming someone.
I think it's beyond charming.
I don't know, I did just roll a 2.
Yeah, just say it doesn't need to get ugly.
Okay,
that's all you're going to say? Well, it doesn't need to get ugly?
Well, if you know what I mean. Just, you know.
I will attempt to charm
particularly
to...
For.
I'll try and like roll the situation with diplomacy. I fail.
He's basically like, tell me why I shouldn't kill you now for asking questions.
It would also brings out multiple grenades.
There's a short form breath of the world. It would be a shame to damage mine.
Really?
I can't help it, it's such a good movie. He's mulling it over. I did get a 2.
Okay. Well, regardless of how much you charm this guy, you're still asking the wrong questions. All right, everyone.
How do we roll for
initiative? Roll initiative.
How do you roll for initiative?
D100, I think it is, plus your
agility bonus.
D10? Okay.
What was that? D10 plus agility bonus.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so I got... I got 12.
My 9 dice is still alive.
Albert has 12.
I got 13.
What's the agility bonus?
I'm thinking Scythia is going first amongst us.
I'm going last. Woo. The only one that actually has a gun.
I do.
I have a gun.
I have a big gun.
I got a last
reliably gun. Big gun.
I have a crossbow, pistol, and throwing knives.
Crossbow one of them in the head.
But you could separate it from his body. But Scythia, something tells me you're going to be using some sort of warp power shortly.
No, I was actually just going to use my gun to start with. Don't want to reveal that I am a psyker.
Yeah, probably bad idea. We don't need to summon the greater. We don't need to summon the greater aspect of Korn here.
I just need to roll Mercutios. So. Ouch. Alright,
So Mercutio and I go on the same turn.
Oh, sorry, that should be ascending, not descending. Who has the higher agility? What's your agility score, Tiber?
30.
Okay, Mercutio goes first. Alright, I all need you all to right click your characters, and if you can, add turn.
No, I don't have any.
No, I don't have.
Okay, I'm gonna have to do it manually then.
Yep.
All right. What was your initiative, Scythia?
13.
13?
Yeah. All right. Mean I go Marnius, first or last?
What's my what?
What's your
12.
All right then. Altos.
7.
Tiberianus.
I too was 12.
I'm going to put you as 12. And Varn.
9.
Alright, I just.
I love how my
initiative
is the worst.
Now for the fat pig.
Ooh, whoops.
He's just going to need a D10. Wow.
We're on feet, not meters as well.
Oh, sorry. It was a new map. I forgot to edit it.
That's okay. We forgive you.
No, you don't. I know you.
You don't know me. No one knows me.
Add turn. Alright, if I...
There's music playing!
I can set it to more epic music.
Probably a good idea, as long as it's royalty-free for free now. Since we are entering our first official combat phase, that doesn't involve me punishing people for groping me.
That didn't happen.
No idea what you're talking about.
Of course not.
Right.
7.
I believe higher initiative is ever. Let me double check.
The fat guy goes last.
It's so like me, for Mercutio, and Varnius. Aren't I supposed to go last of the set since I have 30 agility?
Yes, it should. Okay! Cynthia, you hear the door lock beside you, and you see two thugs barrel up the stairs, guns at the ready. One of them is armed with a las gun, and the other is armed with a simple snub-nosed revolver.
I quick draw my snub automatic.
Let's assume once you guys heard this door click, you went ahead and pulled out your weapons. Sound good?
Okay. Yep. Mm-hmm. I was just assuming that our pistols were still holstered, so I was like... See if I use burst fire, does that actually induce a penalty?
Actually, I believe burst fire increases your chance to hit.
Oh, okay, nice.
I swear you only have 3 shots, though.
Well, yeah, true, but still. If I have burst fire on, I can get rid of one quicker, hopefully. You know?
Okay. Now, the question becomes, is there a penalty for being behind Mercutio? And can he, can Scythia take a 1 meter step and hunker down to be less of a usable target?
I'll just stand behind Mercutio.
Scythia wanted to move here.
Yeah.
You will be firing through him, so that will be a penalty. Okay. Yeah, if you stand there, you can move there and shoot at the same time, but you cannot aim and shoot.
Okay.
So it's essentially you're firing from the hip.
Yeah, I'm going to try and shoot the one middle...
Also, is this music epic enough?
Yeah, that's good enough.
Anyway, I'm going to try and shoot at the one with the last pistol. Which one is it?
This guy's the one with the last gun.
Okay, well, I'm going to try and shoot at him with the last pistol. Okay. Remember, I guess... The D100 and so. So.
Derp. Yes.
Ooh.
I thought you were going to use your auto-fire.
I did. What's the thing we for it?
Oh, then, basically, for each shot, you have to roll.
Okay.
Shot one goes wild. Shot two, is that a hit? What's your ballistic skill?
30.
Okay, so shot two hits, shots one and three miss. Why don't you ever roll where you hit?
I'm just rolling the both of them immediately after each other.
So, hit for 7 damage.
Down the head.
Where'd you hit him?
Down the head, 12.
Right arm.
Right arm, ah.
Well, luckily for you, he has no armor on his right arm. However, basically, hits him in the arm. He grabs his arm, but he's still going strong.
Mm-hmm. Can he still fire his two-handed weapon?
Hmm?
And he still fired.
Yeah. That's a two-handed weapon.
That's gone. That's two-handed. It's a rifle.
He'll take a penalty for shooting it, but not much of one.
Yeah.
Right. Is that all you're doing, Cynthia?
That's all she can do.
Yeah, that's pretty much all I can do, I think.
Fair enough. So it's good. Alright, so next is Varnius.
Me? Yes.
I advise taking out the guy behind you.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say.
Okay.
So, I'm gonna shoot him with... Oh, wait. I could try and cut him with my sword. Yeah, I'll give that a try. Can I take a step closer to him and cut with my sword?
Yeah.
I can't move myself. I'm gonna move myself there. Wait, that way.
You have to check the arrow.
There you go. Step closer to him. Cut him with my sword. So I need to roll. What do I need to roll?
Weapon skill plus strength, I believe.
Weapon skill, which is...
I'm sorry, strength only applies to damage, so just your weapon skill.
Right, so is that the...
1d100.
I need some guidance. 1d100. Oh, sugar. Roll. There we go.
Yes.
Ooh.
That's a
good one. Oh, wow.
What's your weapon skill?
My weapon skill is 22.
Is 22?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's a... Let's see... Just shy of 2 degrees of success, so you have 1 excess degree of success. Why don't you go ahead and roll a your hit, where you hit him.
Is that just 1d100 again?
Yeah.
Yes. Alright, you managed to chop at his right leg.
Right legs have a lot of trouble in this
game. Oh.
Yeah.
Alright, why don't you go ahead and roll damage for me? And instead, double your plus if you have one.
Sorry?
Actually, yeah, just go ahead and roll your damage and I'll tell you what you get.
So, what's that?
What are you using?
Mono sword.
It'd only be a 1d10.
What sword?
It should be on your character sheet.
If you I told you what it was.
That is melee weapons. Sword, melee. 1d10 R. Yeah,
it does 1d10 rending damage with 2 penetration and is a balanced weapon.
Am I doing this right?
Yes.
Go ahead and give some feedback.
Space Monkey just rolled to me.
Oh, sorry. I was just doing that in secret. I was seeing what it'd be like.
Okay, sorry. There's your damage. I didn't see it.
Yeah, so he did okay, six
damage to his leg. Let's go ahead and since he got a degree of success, we're going to go ahead and essentially add 50% to that. So you actually do 9 damage to this guy's right leg.
Awesome.
Ow.
All right, now what does that deal? Does that do any special effects with rending damage?
With rending damage, there's a nice visible gash on his leg. If he were to move or make any agility tests, he would be at a disadvantage.
Awesome. And now he's in close combat, so he can't shoot you without triggering an attack of opportunity unless he uses a melee weapon.
Indeed.
Yes.
All right. Next, anything else you want to do, Barnius? I'm saying Barnius is done.
Yeah, I'm done. All right.
Mercutio, seeing the guy with the las gun, point his gun at him, points his las gun in return. I know. Very, very descriptive, right?
Misses.
And he misses miserably and hits the wall just in front of the guard.
Does that trigger a spray of effects that could cause him to be blinded?
It does not. It just...
Okay.
It hits the roof, the road falls in.
It takes a step back and crouches.
Oh, you can crouch. Oh. All
right.
Bugger.
So it's assumed you crouch. You have a full range of movement. You can even go prone if you want.
Yeah.
Dive to the floor!
All right, I know we haven't discussed this before, but I'm going to go ahead and say... Blue dot means you're a...
Crouched. Yeah.
All right. Tiberianus.
Do we have like free actions? Like, can I see if the fat man is armed?
Like, that would be a perception test. Yes.
And that wouldn't waste my turn. I could still shoot somebody.
Right.
I'm gonna shoot the guard.
Okay. One, the fat man is clearly armed. He's pointing a gun at you.
Oh. Okay. I didn't. Okay. I'm gonna shoot the fat man.
What kind of gun, though?
With my my last carbine, I'm gonna fire 2 bursts at him. A 2-shot.
Birch guard?
No, at the fat man.
What? Oh, okay, you're shooting the fat man?
Yeah.
A source of information?
Ooh, 5. What's your ballistic skill?
If I remember correctly, it is 33.
33. That is 2 degrees of success.
Yeah, let's kill our sources.
If you specifically tell me you're not shooting to kill, yeah, you won't kill him, alright?
Okay. Otherwise, I'm not trying to kill him, just very, very badly burn him.
Shoot his arm so he can't fire.
That'll work. Okay. I roll a 10 on my 2 hit.
Oh.
Where I'm hitting, I mean.
Okay, 10, you hit him in the head.
Just see, he grazes for it. Just grazes for it. Oh god.
You idiot, it doesn't have a stun setting.
Oh, whoa.
Does my last carbine have a stun setting?
How many shots were you?
I fired 2.
And you hit with both. Was the first one?
Let's make the second roll there the second shot.
Okay.
Okay.
See, you guys are rolling fine now.
Okay, so I'm rolling very well to not kill him with 2 shots.
Oh.
Do I roll a location of hit, or do they just count as called shots?
They count as called shots.
I'm gonna shoot him.
Where are you aiming?
Okay then. Now D10 for damage. Yes.
Yes.
Oh, D10 plus 4. 1D10 plus. All right. First shot deals.
13.
13 damage to one of his arms.
You can type in plus 4 in order to automatically add your bonus.
Yeah, but I was using the Slash roll.
Or is that where you're?
Plus 4. And 9 damage to his other arm.
So we have 13 and 9 damage to both of his arms.
In a non-lethal manner.
All right. Unfortunately for you, he is wearing some armor, so it's actually 11 and 7 damage.
Oh my.
To both of his arms. Yeah, let's just say he's not doing too well. Oh, at least his arms aren't doing too well.
Can he hold things right now? Right now?
Hmm?
Can he hold things right now?
Yes.
Damn it.
Interesting.
He's gonna have a massive penalty to his aim, though.
Oh, good.
Oh, great. He might accidentally shoot himself in the head. Yay.
You want to do anything else, Tiberianus?
Well, I'm going to actually move here and crouch behind the desk for cover.
Right, give yourself a blue dot.
Blue dot. Wow.
Okay, Varn.
Okay.
Scribe him to death, Scribey.
I'm sorry.
I'll be in the corner
taking
a log of a battle. I'll be describing in intricate detail. No. I'm gonna pull out my gun. And I'm gonna take a shot at that guard there.
Okay.
I'm using my. I'll use my las pistol.
Okay. No, if you wish to switch guns, that will take a full turn.
Okay. So that's a 1d100.
To miss.
To miss? Okay. I will then crouch behind the table for cover.
Alright, give yourself blue dot.
Okay.
Kaltas, it's up to you!
Oh, crap. Not the room.
So I'm actually doing the best so far.
I'll be back in a second, sorry.
In terms of what I wanted to do.
You and Tiberianus are doing the best so far, and Scythia's in the middle, and everyone else is sucking. Why is there a yellow screen?
Kaltos does.
Kaltos, what do you do?
Lasgun. Extremely good shot.
Mind you, you are sitting down.
And so do we.
You may want to... Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Combat roll off the couch.
Whoop! That's why you did it all along.
Mm-hmm. He's in a very defensible spot, actually.
Yep.
Mm. Alright, go ahead and give yourself a blue dot.
Hmm?
Give yourself a blue dot. I assume you rolled into a crouch.
Yep.
Okay, give yourself a blue dot.
Then I fire at the guy on the couch. My new buddy.
Okay. You gain a plus 10 to hit since he is sitting down.
I get a plus what?
10.
Ooh.
You got it. I'm getting a plus. Let's see. How bad of a failure is that? What is plus 6?
I think only if you hit over 95, you're
33.
Jump.
33. So right now you're shooting as though you have a ballistic score of 44, or 43.
Okay. Yeah, I'm just gonna say that your bolt goes wildly and knocks a leg off the table.
Which table? Which table?
This one.
The one I'm currently crouched. Oh, okay.
That actually gives you increased cover. That would actually give Varn increased cover from this person. Because the table would fall, tilt, and obscure his
Ballmark. But that wouldn't matter because he's already...
not that tall of a table, it's like a coffee.
Yeah. I've already flashed his guy's legs,
I'm that much of a threat to him at the moment.
I know, I'm just going with combat mechanics. Onwards! So now we have...
Alright.
3, 4, 5, 6.
It's now this slug's turn.
Six people shooting at us.
It's now this guy's turn.
Uh-oh.
Oh, shit.
Well...
I'm glad I'm in cover.
Yep. Well, that's good. I apologize for this. I was trying to call back, but you were all busy, so it's like, oh, okay then.
I guess that guy rolled a 100.
He disrupted our communication.
Alright, so what did we miss?
So he takes a shot at Varn and misses horribly.
Yay!
Yay!
Why did Mercutio roll?
Because I was accidentally impersonating him. Then he comes over here, and he crouches behind the desk to get more cover.
It's cheating. It's not allowed tactics.
All right. Next is Garden Hallway's turn.
Which one?
He's going to take a shot at Mercutio. The guy right here.
Who has plus 4 armor.
How do you ping enemy?
Yes, indeed.
You just click and hold.
Ah, okay, cool.
Alright, so Guard is going to roll to hit Mercutio, who is crouched, so even up, blah blah blah. And he misses horribly.
Yay! This is going well.
Next is Guard by Door.
Wow.
He goes to hit Varnius with his butt of his gun.
Ooh, and Varnius can parry. Plus 10 to his parry check.
I can parry. Full dodge.
Indeed. Also, mind you, he gets a minus 10 because he's using an improvised weapon and he has an injured leg.
In addition,
Varnius... Actually, sorry, that doesn't affect his ability.
With a balanced weapon, Varnius also has plus 10 to the parry.
Indeed. So, this would be opposing rolls. For one,
higher,
to see if
higher
he
is
hits.
Better here.
Okay, he does hit. Now go to roll to parry, which would be your agility test.
Is that another D100?
Yeah.
Agility test plus 10 plus your weapon skill.
Mm.
Oh. Mm. Okay.
Mm.
You go to parry and you have to miss it. He goes to hit you and he hits you in the left leg.
My name is Amigo Montoya. You killed my brother.
No, she will
die.
All right. Anyways, an improvised weapon.
Would be bashing damage or impact.
1d10 minus 2. So he does 3 damage to your right leg or left leg, whichever leg it was.
3 impact damage. Don't you have armor, Varnius, on your legs?
I do. I have.
How much armor do you have?
2 armor to each leg.
So he does 1 damage to your leg.
You're going to be very badly bruised in the morning.
Ow.
Ow! Bastard!
Ow.
So I take this from my...
take it from your book.
Yeah.
So just, if you click the bubble and type -1, it'll automatically do that for you.
There you go.
Okay. Now it's Thug on Couch turn.
Wow.
Thug on Couch will imitate Kaltos and roll off the couch.
For he's now an easy target for Vaughn. He's flanked.
Indeed.
Oh, crap.
Alright, and he's going to take a shot at Kaltos.
Good thing he didn't shoot the prone Vaughn.
You notice this guy actually has a shotgun.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
Ruh-roh!
You could probably just mean through the couch in that case.
No, the couch is made of Kevlar.
Again.
Alright, it's scatter, so... See, I believe he hit. He does hit. 33. He hits you in the chest.
Oh, that's right then.
Alright. The pump action shotgun. Where is my ranged weapon? Sure. Actually, it's just gonna be a pump action shotgun. So, roll 1d. And plus 4.
Oh, I take 7 damage.
You have flak armor, yes?
Yes, he does.
I have 5 armor. Plus 5.
Plus 5.
Yeah, because of the disguise.
Did we rule that having additional layers of armor would increase your armor rating?
We did save stack.
Okay, so he's got 5, so that'll only do 7 damage.
7 damage. Ouch.
Unless there's any penetrating.
There's no penetrating.
Shotguns hurt.
Especially at close range.
This is very close range.
That's a 3-meter couch.
That
sounds pretty standard. Alright, other guard in hallway's turn. Bling.
Bling.
He fires at Mercutio as well.
He's bigger and clearly scarier.
84, he misses wildly.
He doesn't know the fate of the psychic next to the guy shooting it.
Oh.
We'd like to keep it that way as long as possible.
The fat man, also known as the boss, as you guys have most likely guessed. Where is his name? It was right here.
Soon it will be Slave of the Empire.
His name is Chord.
Chord.
All right. He has a las pistol, and his arm is injured. So, but he's going to shoot Tiberianus.
Both of his arms are seriously injured.
Yeah. He's going to shoot at you, regardless. But you can take a minus 10 penalty to it.
Mm-hmm. Wasn't he walk point blank into it?
He's legitimately gonna shoot himself in the face, isn't he?
No.
It's not a weapon jam.
No, actually, that's 1 point off from a jam.
Which a last.
I thought it was 95 or above.
I thought it was 96. Huh. Ranged attack rules. Weapon jams, 96 to 100. Oh, that's right. No jam.
Got minus 10, so technically he just rolled a 105.
True. So yeah, let's go ahead and roll a ballistics test. I'm sorry, the weapon fizzles, and his charge pack has to be bumped back into place.
Excellent.
Which he cannot do that this turn, but he does crouch.
Yeah.
So, everyone's your crouched. Turn.
How close do I need to be for point blank?
Right next to him.
Okay then.
Try to avoid that.
Yeah, I just thought I'd ask. I get crouched to start with. Give me a second.
Alright, that'll increase your aim by 5. Oh. If you're using a rifle.
I'm using a pistol, though.
No, still, same. You're braced, so you gain a bonus.
Okay. Well, I'm going to fire at the guard with the laser pistol again. Cool.
You mean laser gun?
Eh?
Lasgun.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Pfft. You said plus 5, yeah?
Yes.
Right, okay. Yeah.
Nothing happens. Are you gonna do anything else?
Can I see if there's a way of opening the door with a perception test?
Currently at the moment, no.
No. Okay, so you can't do it after shooting?
Well, you're too busy focused on shooting this guy.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're in combat.
One round, basically everyone's movements, takes 6 seconds.
Ah, okay.
Varnius.
Right. Is there a way for me to try to directly stab this guy in the chest?
That's a called shot.
Called shot, which is a minus 20.
We want to avoid called shots as much as possible.
And you have to, unlike the first time in which Tiber went, a called shot has to be made beforehand.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I just let him do it because, one, he rolled pretty damn well regardless.
And I would have shot him in the head and blown his head off.
Okay. I'll try regularly attacking him again.
Okay. You slash at the air beside him.
Dang it.
You do, let's see, I believe you have 2 half actions.
Two half? So I can try again?
Yeah, could you have some sort of assassin skill?
I'm half tempted to try unnatural aim. The problem is it's a The problem is it's a psychic ability. Oh.
Do it. What yeah. The
you can make, you can make 2 melee attacks a turn.
Nice. I'm gonna try again.
The problem is it's basically at the edge of my ability if I remember right, because it's something like 9 or above maybe. Give me a second.
Did I hit
the
I don't know. What's your weapon skill?
My weapon skill is 22.
I'm sorry, but you miss.
Damn it.
So you slash at both of this guy's arms and go to either side of him.
I'm intimidated.
Close of a second.
Clearly you are fighting Jet Li.
Alright, I'll leave it at that then.
Okay.
I'll leave it at that.
Mercutio is going to use his turn to change to his shotgun.
Can't he just drop his last gun and switch to it immediately?
He doesn't have quick draw. Tiberianus.
Ha ha. If I shoot him again, he might die.
Why don't you run up and knock him over the head?
Shoot the shotgun, guys.
You know? I could do that. He does not have cover from me, does he?
No, he does not. Although Vorn could be considered in the way, so if you fail horribly, you could hit Vorn.
I think that's an acceptable risk.
Yeah, Varna is right in the way. You could show him to Doc.
Can I delay my move until after Varns?
Can you what?
Can I delay my move till after Varns?
Yeah, I'll allow you to hold it.
Alright.
There's nothing between you and that guy.
But you would have to communicate to Varn, like, hey, move out of the way, or something like that.
Yeah, no, I can't shoot him, because then I'm firing into combat, and then I would take a huge penalty, and I'd risk hitting him. Hitting Varn, yes. That's a bad idea. Screw it! I'm just gonna shoot this guy.
Alright. There's a risk you may hit the boss again.
Yeah.
Oh well. Acceptable.
He's in cover, so take a minus 10.
Minus 10.
Why don't you just shoot this guy?
Another double burst.
Oh well, you may.
I'm not shooting him because they're in, because it's in close combat.
Okay.
Alright. Let's see. Ha! First shot misses. Second shot misses more.
He scorched the top of the desk.
I framed the desk, bitch. In the name of the Emperor and the Order of Malleus, cease and desist and surrender yourselves to our custody.
Persuasion?
No!
Why not roll persuasion?
Yeah, can I? Okay, that was actually an intimidation check to get them to surrender. Because it's the Ordo fucking Malleus.
Then take a fellowship test.
That's a pass.
He's scared, but he's still steeled in his resolve, but he will take a penalty against acting against you.
When you want to intimidate someone, bring out the Ordo Malleus. They're the ones that command the Sterminatus.
Right, as an assassin, Varnius, do you have lightning attack or swift attack?
No. Unfortunately, no.
Then I have made an error in reading the rules in which you may only make one melee attack a turn unless you actually do have a swift attack or lightning attack.
Well, I'm not anyway.
They both missed.
Alrighty. Varn.
Suppose I should be keeping track of how many rounds I have.
Yeah, I've been doing the same. Apparently.
That's why I went for melee attacks.
So, can I possibly vault the desk?
Really, you want to do that?
Really?
You could, but
that would be an agility check. You'd be making an attack of opportunity from two people.
And you would be flanked.
I recommend you just move here and then shoot this guy.
Someone just dropped, I think.
No?
Okay.
I'm going around. No, we're all here.
Everyone important is here.
Okay. Hey, well, I was considering trying to get my way over here and try and get my, like, take him as a hostage. But seeing as I can't do that unscrupulous tactic, I will take a shot at this guy.
Tiberianus has disappeared on this.
What?
On the list of names and pictures and stuff, Tiberianus has disappeared from me.
I'm right here.
Oh yeah, that's
okay. I see you.
Yeah.
But I don't see you on the bottom list of names. Yeah, no.
You don't list of names.
I'm off on the right.
Oh, well, I'm sure it's nothing.
I'm on the far right.
I know where you are, but it's just not showing up in the names.
Who are you shooting at, Barnes?
This guy.
Come on. They're not ping, fine.
The dead ping.
Your ruler.
Okay. I pinged it for you.
Okay.
Even with the plus five, the close range and openness. Yeah, you're not gonna hit, are you?
Yeah, I know. No.
Alright.
Can I take a step this way?
This way? Which way?
That way.
No, you can take a you can take a one, you can take a 5 foot step.
You can move up to let's see,
3 meters, yeah.
Varn. Yes. Yes, 3 meters.
Okay, nice. I could all move all the way there.
Well,
that would work.
Okay, yeah, I'll do that. I'll move over here then.
Are you still crouching behind the? Are you crouching behind the coffee table now?
Yeah.
Okay.
He duck waddled.
Wada.
What's the accuracy increase to point blank?
Plus 30.
I think it's like,
Plus 30.
Plus 30.
Range attack rules.
You can move that.
Oh, here's the rules for unarmed attack.
Can I take a burst fire shot into this guy at point blank?
Yes. Yes, you can.
Damn. Wow.
He is not happy with any choice. Yes.
Hold on, let me actually look up to see if burst fire is a...
I think burst fire is a full round.
Yeah.
And these guys were friends.
3 rounds, isn't it?
Of course, now you're also point blank to a man with a shotgun.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a risk.
You better hit.
I've got 3 rounds of point blank accuracy.
If you're allowed to have 3 rounds, that is.
It's 3 rounds.
I was just staring at it, and now I don't see it.
That's all in the game.
This is how you treat your friends.
Is it a full auto burst? Because full auto burst is a full action.
It's not a full auto, it's
burst.
A semi-auto burst. Full auto would have been the third round, this is only, it's the middle.
So it's just a burst shot?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, semi-auto burst is still a full action.
You can fire a shot.
So I can only fire one shot?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You could try to shove a grenade down his throat.
It's a big sis.
Actually, I'm going to cancel that move, and I will throw a grenade.
Oh, yeah.
What kind of grenade?
Are you going to try and throw it about here?
Yeah, sort of throw it into there.
What's the blast radius on that?
3 meters each way.
All right, so if you throw it there for 3 meters each way, you're gonna hit the boss. I recommend hitting it here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Onto the side.
I believe it's 3 meters anyway. Could you the GM check that?
You'll have to roll scatter and stuff like that though. Oh.
I'm so glad I moved.
You're throwing a firebomb?
Yeah.
Okay, because the standard frag grenade is a blast 4.
I would take out half this room.
Aim it right in the corner.
And aim it well.
Now, the firebomb grenade is a 1d10 plus 3 energy weapon with 2 penetration and blast 3.
Mine says 6 penetration.
I'm looking at the Dark Heresy rules, so. Yeah, page 137 on the core rulebook.
Yes, oh, 131.
137.
On 131, though.
Don't argue with my increased penetration skills.
You're only harming yourself.
So, do I have any for this?
Sure.
Any role I need to take for this?
Yes. Various.
Hmm?
What roles does he have to make to throw a grenade and not kill us all?
That would be a strength test based on a strength bonus with ballistics test.
It's a plus.
Let's just say I didn't make that.
What you missed?
You rolled a 49.
Oh, there's special rules for this.
Yeah, it's that juicy scattering and stuff like that. You need to roll a 1d10 if I remember right.
Sometimes when playing thrower weapons, it is important to know where the weapon lands should you fail your ballistic skill test. On a failed roll, the GM, me, rolls a 1d10 and consults the scatter diagram. Alright, so roll 1d10.
Well, this could fuck you and Vaughn, Tyler.
7. You were throwing it where?
Here.
I think it goes over in this direction.
There?
Yeah, it was there.
Yeah.
I think it's going over this way.
Alright. And then roll 1d5 to determine how far it rolled. 2 meters.
Oh, wow. Okay. Right on top of this guy here.
Actually, it lands here.
Yeah, right on top of this guy, no?
Oh, I see.
Oh, okay.
Well.
You!
You said it was a 3-meter range?
Wouldn't the desk also deflect the force of the blast?
Towards the boss, yes.
Hit that guy.
Towards the boss landing.
Hit that guy.
It would reflect the boss landing here? Because the death is between the boss and the fire explosion.
I would say the fire would stop about 2 meters. No, I'm sorry. The desk could catch on fire, and since he's crouching behind it, he should be fine.
Okay. But that couch is fucked.
That couch is now on fire.
All right, there's a guy right behind it.
We need damage for the two thugs and the couch, then.
What would that be? 1d10?
Also, I'm going to start thinking about how to put the fire out. Since we are sealed in the room and the controls are behind the desk.
Is it 1d10 plus 10? Plus 4?
The fire bomb is 1d10 plus 3. Okay, that's 6 damage. Let's see, they're wearing blah blah blah. Okay, 6 damage to this guy. Bing. And let's see, that puts him there. I'm sorry, no, that puts him there. And 9 damage to this guy. That puts him there. All right, they're going to have to make agility tests to avoid being put on fire. All right, this guy. He fails. This guy also fails.
Yes!
Burn, bitches.
This girl is burned out.
Alright, they take... This guy takes an additional damage.
Damn, a crit.
What?
Critical fire damage.
Oh, max damage. Max damage, not a crit.
Sorry.
Is that how it works? Damage dealt determines critical hit?
It
should be based on the roll.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
If you roll a 1,
you're gonna do some serious shit.
Alright. You still have a half turn, but you did throw something.
I say you use the extra half turn to fist pump.
Can I?
Yes.
Could he not throw a second grenade?
No, he cannot.
Okay.
No,
he did not fire his gun.
No, he cannot. He already used the weapon action.
Oh, okay.
He can stand up.
No. I think you should just stay there.
Yeah.
And, like, peer over the edge of the couch, make sure you don't light on fire.
He's changing the fire set gun half action.
Also, I think the table is now on fire.
The table is on
fire. The table in the center was made of metal.
Oh, okay. It might
the table is eating up. The table which I'm standing behind is heating up.
No, it's not. You see fire sprayed everywhere. But yes, the couch is also on fire.
What about the carpet?
Actually, anything I can do.
Well, the carpet extended here. So, this portion of the carpet, right here.
Altos, can I suggest that you move back away from the couch just in case it ends up burning you?
No, it should be fine for now. It does have spread damage, I think. It spreads. And... I'm just doing a test here, make sure this works. Pay no attention to it. Okay, good, it worked.
We were done.
He's dying of smoke inhalation. Alright.
You guys almost
in now it's time for minions to move.
Alright, the pug is on fire. He must make a agility test to avoid running around screaming.
Wouldn't that be willpower?
Let's see. To put out fire? I wish I could will fire away.
No, to willpower to control yourself, not to go around panicking.
Well, he decides to make an agility test. Actually, yeah. So, willpower test. He's still running around screaming, and he fails to put out the fire.
Means he takes more fire damage. Lanterns have taught me well.
Actually, the fire damage will take place on Kaltos' turn.
Mm. Woo.
Alright, now it's Thug and Hallway's turn. He's going to shoot at Mercutio again.
Yay!
And he misses horribly.
Yay!
Thug by Varnius' turn. He goes to hit Varnius, and he fails horribly.
As it should be.
Let's see, it was... I think I may be getting these two mixed up, but since they're in order anyway, it doesn't matter. Other thug in hallway also attempts to fire at Mercutio and fails miserably.
Yay!
Thug behind couch is on fire and attempts to put out fire and fails miserably.
He is now running away. Fire is fun.
All right. The boss of the operation, also known as Chord. Notices two of his men burst into flames and must make a willpower test and fails miserably.
In addition to the negative will of being threatened by a perceived member of the Ordo Malleus.
Yeah.
Is he incapacitated with fear?
For this turn. Yeah.
Oh. So not for the whole... Okay.
Can the actions inside the room be heard in the hallway by Scythia and Mercutio?
Yes.
Or is it a soundproof room?
It is not soundproof.
That means people downstairs are wondering what the fuck is going on.
Well, we have been firing our gun in the hallway.
Let's hope they don't have reinforcements, otherwise we might have to sell a lot of barrels of the warp test.
Put the frogs.
Oh, anyway. Again, I'm just going to try and shoot the one with a large rifle, but this time I'm going to do it with the thingway. Burst fire. Again.
Okay.
Okay, so 1, 2, 3. I hit the last one.
Do any of those hit?
I hit the last one.
Okay, go ahead and roll location and damage.
There we go. Oh, that's pathetic, though. Oh, head, though. No, that's not head. What am I talking about? Yeah, I have.
I thought 10 was head. What's 84? 84 is the head?
No, I made a mistake. Was that left leg?
I don't even see it.
84.
84 and then the 5.
Oh. 84 is his right leg. 84 is his right leg.
Okay.
What's with people with right legs?
5 damage. Yeah, since he's, he's just gonna take 5 damage. You gonna do anything else?
No, can't really do anything else, to be honest, though. There's nothing really to move to.
Luckily, thugs usually tend to focus on the most powerful enemy instead of picking off the weaker victims.
He's also the guy, Mercutio is also the guy with the fuck-off shotgun.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, Vornius.
Right, let's try attacking this guy again.
Damn it. Our assassin keeps one of the thugs busy.
I'll let you make the second melee attack.
You have to roll like 22 or better, so.
One day.
Alright. Mercutio is going to fire at, well, both these cards. They're scattered, but he's going to focus on this guy. Alright, let's impersonate Mercutio. Roll 1d100. Ah, yes, I believe that's a hit.
It better be for a guardsman.
Yeah, his ballistic skill is 38.
Mm. Hey, the guardsman's done a lot of damage here.
Yeah, so yeah, he does hit.
Better hit since he's a guardsman.
Oh, wait,
he
do I know?
The head.
Oh, bugger, I just remembered. I have a plus 10 because of the skills.
Wouldn't matter, you'd still miss.
I know. I just remembered, though, for future reference.
Alright, so he hits in the head, and we go and look up the, double check to see what the shotgun damage is. 1d10 plus 4. Does 13 damage to the fucker.
In the face.
To the head, yes. And mind you, half of that scatters onto the other guy, which the scatter hits him, 41, blah, blah, blah. Hit location table, 41. Hits him in the chest. So he takes 6 damage. I'm going to have to go into a different table for this.
So many tables. Makes you wish you had the actual book, huh?
Actually, it's a lot easier for me to, a lot quicker for me to do it this way. Impact, critical, body. Attack knocks the target sprawling on the ground. The target flies 1d5 meters away and falls prone.
Down the stairs.
So, 8 meters.
No matter what, he basically goes down the stairs and... Yeah, considering he fell downstairs.
After being shot in the chest with a shotgun?
Yeah, he's gone.
Scythia, make sure that nobody steals his stuff.
I'm just moving up here because I couldn't get to that. Alright, anyways, so that guy falls down just from a careless attack. This guy takes 13 damage to the head. Let's see. Which puts him. Impact, critical. Head. The impact fills the target's head with a terrible ringing noise. The target must take a test toughness or take 1 level of fatigue.
That's pretty damn good for being shot in the face with a shotgun.
1 level of fatigue.
He does pass the toughness test. He's also blinded by, lead and blood, so he will take any penalties.
Don't forget to mark him as blind.
Yep.
How far is that spray again?
Sometimes it is.
How far is that spray
again? You're on a 2-meter wide hallway, there's not much to decide.
Yeah, I was just wondering how far is the spread, though?
You mean the scatter attack?
It's just the guys next to him.
Oh, right, sorry, I thought his head blew up.
No.
Ah.
No, half the damage spread over onto the other guy, hitting him in the chest.
Ah.
And he was flung backwards, just as men hit by shotguns are supposed to be.
Okay, Tiberius, you hear a loud shotgun blast and someone tumbled down some stairs. Mm-hmm. You hope it wasn't one of your allies.
What did they think when the grenade went off?
Yeah, well, what did the customers think downstairs?
Well, a firebomb doesn't make a loud boom. It's basically...
Yeah, but they would start to be going, oh, look, I smell burning human.
It basically smells like a Molotov. It sounds like a Molotov cocktail going off.
So I took a 5-foot step right next to the boss. I'm planning on hitting him. Would it be better to hit him with my fist or with my gun?
Gun.
Gun. I'm going to
smash... By the way, he gets an attack of opportunity against you.
5-foot step. It's a 1-meter step.
Oh, wait, no, you're right. Sorry, my bad. Sorry.
5-foot steps still apply even when they're in 1-meter increments. Alright, so I'm gonna hit him with a melee. That's an improvised weapon, right?
Yes, if you hit him with your gun.
You hit the table.
He's gonna counterattack with a big meaty fist.
Oh, wow!
And his...
Does he have like negatives to everything he does against me?
Let's see, minus 10. No, you're right. He misses with his negatives.
He's got like negative 30 at this point.
Yeah, he's scared of you. He's
terrified by the fact
and...
that his guys are on fire.
So,
what
yeah,
this
with his big meaty fist.
Alive?
This guy's gonna be shell shocked by the end of this.
Good. He's gonna be submitted to the kind mercy of the Inquisition, anyways.
Oh.
Since he was frightened, that was a flail wildly. So, yeah, he just...
Surrender, damn it!
All right, Varn, you just saw a fire grenade go off. You heard a shotgun blast and someone tumble down some stairs. What do you do?
Well, you,
two people in this room are on fire.
Calm
yes.
The one with a shotgun, please.
I believe I shall try and take a shot at this guy for the third time.
I'll hit somebody sometime.
Okay. Since he's standing, I forgot to remove the crouched thing.
Oh yeah, because they're on fire.
So, regardless, you miss.
Well. Yep.
Okay. You want to do anything else for him?
I think I'm gonna... How many moves can I take? 3? Like, steps?
Yes.
Okay, I think I will move... to there. I will shuffle my way over towards Varnus.
That would be considering the angle of that move.
You have to go there through, then, over.
That would count through left terrain.
Yeah, just move here.
I'll move there. Okay. I mean... Come on, don't
You could
move.
Always crawl under the metal table.
It is true, and it is slightly elevated. Because the other leg was blown off.
Is it like a standard table, or is it like a solid base table? But it's got legs, it's got to be a normal table.
It's got legs.
Yeah.
Shoot their kneecap!
Is that safe?
You could crawl under the table, lie prone, and shoot people.
Kaltos, your turn.
I've not been able to shoot people when I've got a clear line of sight. My plan is just to shuffle towards the door and trying to find a way to open it.
Fair enough. Do I have a clean shot on these two people on fire?
Yep. They're standing.
And because I haven't
moved,
I can burst my weapon, can't I?
They're basically running around in a circle on fire, so do count that as -5 for moving target.
But then I get +5 for weapon skill.
So it's normal.
Yes.
You could hit anything in this room because your range is most likely 30 meters. Yes, you can, as long as you do not move.
It's 100 meters. Yeah. I'm going to burst fire him.
Right in the face!
Okay.
Burst fire that guy. So I have a real vendetta against him.
You used to be my friend!
You rebuffed his advances.
Oh, hit. Miss. Miss.
No, that might be a hit. No, it's a miss.
Yeah, it's a miss.
Alright, roll for one hit location.
Just remember, for the price of one bullet, you can eat three pieces of cheesy toast.
Hands one bullet over. Hands one bullet over.
Where do I hit him?
I think that's the chest.
12 is the right arm.
No, 49.
12 is the gun. 49. The damage. 49 is the... Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm sorry. 49 is the chest. My bad.
Boom.
12 damage to the chest with a 2 armor, with a 2 armor, so you do 10 damage.
And he's on fire.
And he's on fire. So those two guys both take their fire damage.
Then. Okay, down to the injury table. What were you shooting him with?
Laz gun.
So energy?
Yeah.
Energy crit to body.
Like
the target is completely encased in fire, melting his skin and popping his eyes like superheated eggs. He falls to the ground as a blackened corpse.
So he made him extra flame.
That should have psychological effect on the boss.
And everyone else.
Yeah.
Like, and on their allies, at least. We don't care. I hope you're not. I'm insane already.
We are on the service of the Emperor. We don't give a damn.
I was cleansing his soul with flames.
Bless the holy fire of the Emperor's steel fist.
I was screaming, burn, bitch, burn.
Disco Inferno.
That song also survived! Damn!
I'm glad I bought 4 of these grenades.
What?
I'm glad I bought 4 firebombs.
Well, they're cheap, they're like 5 credits a piece.
Yeah, I know.
Just walk into a bar, buy some alcohol, and make them. Just throwing Molotov cocktails.
I have a feeling I should get one.
What about this guy? He still needs to take his resist burning to death charge.
No, sorry, because I forgot that Mark called us as done. I was waiting for more, and also for you guys to comment on how everyone is dying.
Everyone's dying! We're not dead yet! This is
okay. Serious. Guy, go ahead and make an agility test to try putting out the fire. He
failed miserably.
Oh, I forgot to take this 1d5 damage.
And
he takes 5 damage.
That guy's unlucky.
It's really unlucky. You took the flames last time, didn't you?
Let's see. Attack cooks the flesh on the chest and adds him inflicting 2 levels of fatigue and leaving the target stunned for 1 round.
So he can't even put out the fire. In addition to the likely physical trauma of watching his friend incinerated. Or his
he's kind of resigned to his fate now. He's like, oh.
Is there a bald icon? His hair will have burned off by this point.
This is what happens when you fight guardsmen.
When you fight guardsmen inside while they're wearing armor. When you fight guardsmen outside, it's usually the opposite.
There. Does that count as a bald icon?
Good enough. Ah! My hair!
Tiny hair.
Okay. Guy in hallway is... Let's see, that one's dead. Okay, guard next to door.
Show me what you got.
Watch.
He's going to take an improvised swing at you. He misses horribly.
Oh, yeah.
Other guard. Blind and stunned. So we're not even going to worry about him. He did take a shotgun blast to the face after all.
After the boss. who has been told the second time, son of a fuck render.
He's gonna make a willpower test. He fails his willpower test miserably.
That's in the card.
He actually shits himself.
He's like, why did I pick a fight with these people?
And he decides to run.
Into a corner.
Provoking an attack of opportunity.
Into the fire?
Yeah. He runs this way. He basically knocks the on fire guy to the ground.
Now he
and runs to the
phone cab.
He ran through the fire.
Yeah. Isn't that entire area on fire?
Yeah, pretty much.
People caught on fire.
But surely the ground would be on fire as well if it's carpet.
You know, it would burn that by now. Only the center strip is carpet, right, in this area.
Okay.
The desk is on fire.
Okay.
But the desk is metal.
I'll trust you.
That is carpet.
Well, now it is metal. Quiet you. Alright, you want to roll your attack of opportunity?
Yes. I'm going to try to smack him again. I smack him with the butt of my gun.
Alright, so instead of successfully fleeing into the corner, he topples onto the ground.
Ah, fuck!
Rolled in the crowd.
Just like, doink.
Can I roll everything else, or can we just assume that he's unconscious now?
Roll for damage.
That's a 1d100. What do I roll?
I'm 1d10. No, 5. I think it's 1d10.
Okay, so you did hit him. You hit him in the...
leg, I think.
Torso?
34. You hit him in the chest.
Uh-huh. Okay. What do I roll for damage? 1d5 minus something?
Yeah, you hit him with your butt of your gun?
Yeah.
Improvised is 1d10 minus 2.
Hmm. Bad.
Wow, knuckle dusters are pathetic.
I heal him for 1 point of damage. No, I'm joking.
yeah, which does that? No, I do minimum damage.
You soothingly
you
stroke him.
So that one of his dislocated arms go back into its socket.
You soothingly stroke him.
There, it'll be okay until they kill you.
You do 1 damage, and you essentially knock the wind out of him. Alright, Cynthia, your turn. I wonder how many people are going to like to say, there's no attack to opportunity in Dark Heresy. Who cares, we're having fun.
Can I try and perceive...
we're having fun.
Can I try and perceive the door then shoot at him?
I
am like to see if there's a key card or something on one of these guys, maybe.
One or the other.
Wouldn't you be intelligent enough to realize that since he closed the door from his desk, you would have to open the door from his desk?
Yes, but the guys outside might also need a way in, you know? So if they have a key card that could open the door, then charge in.
Hey, there's a boss in his room with 3 pretty tough thugs. No, I meant you guys, of course. You think he's scared?
Yes.
He just wants whoever he's beating the crap out of to not run away and for no one else to come in and disturb his handiwork.
Okay,
just,
fine.
Just kill the last guy.
Yeah, I'll...
just shoot him. He's blind and stunned.
I'm going to do a single shot. And hit. I believe it hit, yeah.
Okay. Roll
again,
location.
Plus 15. Let's see if this worked. I tried to edit the macro a bit.
Auto pistol location equals damage. And, okay, so 54, 54, 54. I keep switching away from that table. 54 is the body.
Okay.
And you do 9
damage.
Damage.
9 energy damage to the torso. Oh,
can
no,
I fire
pistol.
Again?
Impact. Nope, not impact. Yeah, impact.
Yeah, impact.
Were you... okay. I mean, pull up the table. Impact, critical... body. The target jerks back from the force of the attack, throwing back his head and spewing out a jet of blood before crumpling to the ground dead.
And sliding down the stairs.
<That's awesome. laughs> Hold on, I need to throw the X on him.
Yay!
That's fun.
Okay, then. That was a half turn. Are you going to do anything else?
Can I try kicking the door down?
No, you cannot.
That would be a combat attack versus the door. Also, Mercutio is in the way. Also, Mercutio would probably have a better chance of kicking down the door.
Probably. One minute, let's see what my strength is. 27. Yeah, I'll just wait.
Varnius, your turn. You just heard a body fly down the stairs again.
Right. One last try slashing this guy. Come on, dice. Damn it!
You want to make a second attack?
Go on, oh.
Damn. You know, you should just
use your melee skill, your weakest skill.
Yeah, it is. But on the other hand, he's kept this guy from being able to shoot anybody this whole time, so he is doing pretty damn good.
That is true.
Alright, Mercutio's turn. He's going to make a strength test against the door. He's going to shoulder check it and try and push it, knock it down. He injures his foot. I'm sorry, he shoulder checked it. He doesn't injure his shoulder. He basically flunks in the door and everyone in the room is loud.
What's his strength anyway?
His strength is 30. Tiberianus.
Okay, so is the boss unconscious?
No. He is knocked prone, though.
Is there anything fancy I can do to just, like, knock him out?
Make a cold shot against the head?
To try opening the door.
Yeah, I want to cold shot him and knock him unconscious.
Make a cold shot against the head with a plus 20.
Booyah!
With a sickening crack, you hit him upside the back of the head as he slumps to the ground, seemingly lifeless. All you know is he's not moving.
Okay, do I have enough time to be awesome to shoot his buddy?
You do not.
Yeah.
Actually,
so I'm just going to put my foot on his back.
You could have done it from where you were.
Dominatrix.
Whip around his neck, foot on his back.
Note to self.
Oh, this isn't Soul Calibur.
Barn.
Okay,
just remember, I can install tentacles.
Oh.
Can I move through Barnius to the door?
Alternatively, you could offer him flanking bonuses by moving here.
He doesn't really have a melee weapon.
He's got a big
metal
staff.
I haven't
thought
I have to switch to it.
I thought you had a staff.
Yeah.
Well, whatever. Do what you want.
You can also hit him with your gun.
You could take a 5-foot step move here and assist Varnius in combat. I think that gives him bonuses, but that might just be D&D.
Okay, then I'll help Varnius then. I shall rise from my stance of crouching behind the table and approach. Yeah.
Alright, remove your blue dot.
Well, as soon as... There we go. And I will... Can I try to hit him with the butt of my gun?
Yes, but take a minus 5 for moving as in the same turn.
Mm. Okay.
I would have laughed at that.
Wait.
What is the 5 you'd need to do if you were doing that?
I need plus 5. There you go.
Well, you failed both times either way.
Yep, doesn't matter.
Paltos! You killed the fucker. You burned into a charred corpse. You hear a loud crack from behind the desk, and that's pretty much it.
Also, the
fucker
opened the door.
Is the second guy dead, or is he still alive? The one next to the boss?
the one next to the boss is...
He's take his fire damage.
He's stunned as well.
Will. Actually, let's just... He needs to take his fire damage first.
Is he dead yet?
Hold on. God, you people are impatient.
I want him dead.
As the attack washes over the target, his skin turns black and peels while body fat seeps out of his clothing and armor. Target is stunned for 2d10 rounds and attack has his strength, toughness, and agility. The extensive scarring permanently has the target's fellowship characteristics.
We made him ugly if he lives.
I don't think he will.
I'd like to shoot at him.
Oh, regardless. Yeah, go ahead. Shoot at him. He's stunned for 12 turns.
Oh.
Okay, let's not shoot at him. Can I change my weapon to my axe?
Yes. That's a full action, though.
Hmm. Yeah.
Unless you have
I can't move. I do not. And end my turn.
All
and
right.
Now I'll put my axe.
Guy behind desk is on fire and stunned and balding and, well, ugly. He can't do jack crap.
He's been turned into a naked ball rat.
Alright, the guard that has been exchanging blows with Varnius unsuccessfully says, fuck this, I'm going to shoot you with my gun.
So he's going to take huge penalties for shooting in close combat. No, wait, that's point blank.
Yeah.
Yep. Actually, he's going to shoot Varn, the newcomer.
Still messes.
Terribly.
Phew. Thank goodness, because that would be just my luck. I've done nothing productive throughout the entire of this battle.
And he's going to take a step here.
Provoking no attack opportunity to do with the fact that it is a 5-foot step.
The boss is unconscious. Sophia!
Can I put away my gun and quick draw my staff to try and whack at the door?
If you have quick draw. But you can't get out of Mercutio's in the way.
Ah. I was just going to try and head the headpiece.
You should step out of the way, though.
You could always go down the I shouldn't be giving you advice, so you can't hear me.
Well, I could through the wall, but still. Yeah, I request Mercutio to step aside.
Meaning fire or gun?
I request Mercutio to step aside, yes. And I'll try and smack the hinges with the staff.
As a free action.
Okay, and I'll try and smack it with a staff, which is 1d10.
Well, one, roll to see if you even hit the door.
Yeah.
Which is, by the way, at a plus 30, because it's a standing still object.
And you miss.
You swing at the door, and with all your staff makes a loud ringing noise as it bounces off.
Oh. Can I move back out the way?
Yes, I'll let you take that as a reaction.
I'll also move back out of the way so you, Mercutio can try. We're like taking turns each.
Morning.
Right. Oh no, I can't change fucking gun on. No, because I haven't got quick draw. So, but I can take a step smart. Forward and
try and stab him again.
Yeah.
Right. And you're standing, so your walk is actually 6 meters.
Ooh, hit!
Yay!
It seems in order to hit, you have to approach them and swing before you're in front of them. Because your arms are so damn long.
Right. Where did I hit him?
97.
Left leg?
This is the war against legs. You just hit him in the left leg.
I got his right leg now, it's the left leg's
turn. I actually think that's a crit, is it? No, wait, no. Never mind. Not good enough for a crit. Okay, so just roll your damage.
And that is, what's that again?
You should have this on your character sheet.
Yeah, but I have to keep switching what pages I'm looking at.
Varnius, sword,
1d10.
You can set it up as a macro, Jordan.
Your scratch is like...
Damn it!
You have marked him for the hunt.
The wild hunt?
Well, even if you hit, you can't hit him well.
He did pretty good the first time.
Yeah, he did. Mercutio attempts to shoulder check down the door again. Like, remember to impersonate him. And fails miserably. Tiberianus.
Tiberianus is going to look under the desk for the button to open the door.
Yeah.
It is a very obvious button.
I'm going to press the button and open the door. Preferably just as Mercutio tries...
The desk explodes.
What?
The desk explodes. That was the wrong button. No. Okay, joking now, but you, all of a sudden
I
hear
save
the,
against the damage.
Everyone hears the door click open. That was a free action to do that. What do you want to do next?
Oh, is this guy still alive?
He's stunned for 12 turns. He's on fire.
There's no punch. There.
Probably not.
We're gonna walk over there and try to put him on put out the fire on him.
Really?
Wait a second.
Why?
Okay.
Information? So that he has to live the rest of his life as a horribly
deformed. That's what we got this guy for.
So I'm not gonna be able to do anything else. I can't shoot anyone, and I'm not gonna
just shoot him. Just execute him.
That is misery.
Fine, I'll execute him.
Because if you don't, I'm coming over
there
with my axe.
I missed. Are you happy?
Or do you want to shoot him? If you failed horribly, Tiber, I would have had you catch on fire.
Hold on. what bonuses do I get? Because I have a ballistic skill of 33, and it's point blank.
He's stunned, so plus 10, plus 30.
Plus total, so.
Yeah.
You hit him in the white leg.
7 damage
for 7.
And what'd you hit him with?
7-6 with my las rifle or las carbine.
Did you hit him with the actual
No, I shot him.
Bolt, or did you hit him? Okay.
For 7 damage.
Energy critical, and you hit him, who cares where you hit him? Well, actually, for narrative test, where did you hit him? Was this 76 where you hit it, for where you hit him?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so you hit him in the right leg, because cross legs.
You hit him in the legs, I can't crawl away!
He's on fire.
Let's see. In a terrifying display of power, the leg immolates and fire consumes the target completely. The target dies in a matter of agonizing seconds.
Good thing he was unconscious.
Not unconscious, just stunned.
Well, now he'll be forever stunned.
You're horrible.
Alrighty.
Can we roll a check to see if Mercutio went stumbling through the door after I opened it?
I was wondering if we'd end up checking to see if someone gets smacked in the face with it.
Yeah. Does it open in or out?
It opens inwards. He stumbles in. Last time he tried to stumble.
Okay. I am going. Seeing as I can't hit anything worth a damn, I am going to demand the guy surrender.
Roll your check. That is a fellowship chest.
Fellowship test plus 20.
No, I did it.
Alright, he's gonna make a willpower test. He fails his willpower test. And he basically drops his weapon.
Don't kill me!
And throws his hands up in the air and yes.
Don't kill me! I don't wanna die! I don't wanna die!
Hey guys, I finally did something useful.
You used the power of your voice.
Sit the fuck down!
To be fair, we did set two of his mates on fire and burn them alive.
Yeah. You want to end up like them?
He shot the other two down the stairs.
Right, successfully intimidate the thug.
I mean, the guy was completely incapacitated and on fire, and our tech priest walks over and shoots him in the leg and incinerates him.
I was gonna put out the fire so that he would live with horrible agony for the rest of his life, but... No.
Basically, what just happened was, we came in to look for one guy.
You came in, wanted information, you fucked with us, and we killed you all. I commence the looting!
Hyperion. Yes. Can I loot the guy with a shotgun? With the combat shotgun? Or pump action?
Actually,
considering it burned up...
Before we start...
Can I give it to the tech priest? Fire. To fix.
Hmm?
Damn, I was going to ask for that.
Actually, yeah, let me go and make a roll for that.
Let's put out the fire.
As the DM. Yeah, the fire has fizzled out by now.
Oh, okay. Thank
it was
God.
It was an asbestos couch.
Oh, joy. Oh. It probably could be, too.
Eh.
Slaughtered down on the couch. All right, everyone. Somebody knock out that guard and steal his things.
What did that guard have, anyway?
Just a normal rifle.
They were las guns, weren't they?
No, I mean, what did this one have?
Had a shotgun, and everyone else had las guns.
So this one has the las gun?
Mind you.
He had a shotgun.
Which one?
No, I was talking about this
one. Taltos, I assume you said you wanted to loot this guy?
Yeah.
Alright, you pick up the shotgun, and through the extreme heat of the fire and this guy being on fire... all of the ammo has been rendered useless, and the barrel is warped.
I'm going to see if I can fix it.
Wouldn't the ammo have exploded?
It was actually a pump action shotgun, not a bat shotgun.
Yeah,
I can't
pump
fix
action is better than my goal.
I cannot fix it.
Okay.
I rolled a 60.
So
despite my plus 15 for tech use...
So, you break it. Worse.
No. I technically failed by about 10 or 15 points.
Alright, oh, mind you, these blue lines here in the back are denoting windows.
Oh, I'm gonna look out the window and see what's happening. Quick, everyone, get to looting before the enforcers get here.
He got shot in the
you
head.
Push the curtains aside, and you see some more thugs enter the building below, as well as some enforcers just pushing people out of the way to see what the commotion is.
Loot quickly!
Judging by how crowded it is out there and the thugs trying to keep the enforcers out, you say about 10 minutes.
Can we run away?
We'll
say next at 5 minutes.
Guy have on him.
Is there a back door?
You knock him out. You knock him out, yes?
Yes.
Okay. Alright.
Can I roll for awareness? To see any
just quickly, why don't we actually just knock him out because he's heard of what we're... No, kill him properly because he's heard where we're from what arm we're on.
We're not meant to...
Yeah, but we're not meant to unveil where we're... what we're working
this
for.
This is the grim dark of the 41st millennium.
So just kill him.
But he did surrender.
Yeah, but kill him.
I was going to try
tie him up and take him
for information.
Yeah, tie him up and take him. We'll tie him and the boss up and we'll take them.
Oh, right, okay. Yeah, well, but after that we have to kill them because they know what
we're
working for.
Oh, yeah, we're going to dump their bodies in the middle of the... We're going to dump their bodies in the protein.
Oh, of course, there can't be any loose ends. It's just we need some sort of guarantee that we're going to get out of here alive.
Yeah.
Maybe taking
and we're not very good at talking to people.
If it comes to worse, we can send our psyker down to test the barrels with the warp.
Yep.
yeah.
We've got an auto-destruct button.
Wait a minute, I can jump... I can actually jump down and float, remember, so I could just jump out the windows and float people down.
That seems like a bad idea, because then you'll be right
here.
Whereas we want
yes.
to...
I just rolled away.
There's also a window here.
Yeah.
Where escape exits.
Okay, you know you have the windows on the north end of the room.
Yep.
And you remember when coming up through the, up the stairs, you saw a window at the end of the corridor.
We're gonna have to jump out a window, aren't we?
Hey, get to looting! Sophia, Mercutio, loot the bodies at the bottom of the stairs. Everyone else, Brand second.
I'm going to run over to here.
Okay, I'm going to rifle through the desk with a 16 perception.
So how do you loot enemy?
Okay.
Just like the guy over here.
Grab everything they have.
Yeah, I was wondering if it was like an agility or a perception or something.
Ted Arianis, rifling through the desk, you actually find a couple of useful items. Okay. You find a charge pack for a las pistol. You find about 300 thrown geld. I mean, this guy was a drug dealer afterward.
Ooh,
after
nice.
All right, let me go.
Let me, I'm going to write this down as a physical copy. Yeah. Alrighty.
Alright. There is also a flash grenade, a blind grenade in the desk as well.
Nice. He should have used that.
He didn't really have an ampant.
It's essentially a smoke grenade. So
flashbang.
Did any of the drugs on the table survive a battle? Can we, like, take them and sell them?
That would be heretical.
Why would it be heretical? We are using the instruments of the enemy to further fuel the grand noble cause of the Inquisition.
But dirt in your hands is still dirt in your hands.
Taking the drugs yourself would be fine. Selling the drugs would not.
Oh, okay.
What about using them to bribe other people?
No, you could use that to bribe other people.
Okay. So, 300 gold, last just a charge pack, blind grenade, what else?
Blind grenade is actually a smoke grenade, so let me go ahead and refresh that.
I'll go ahead.
You also notice a data slab.
What would it be to jump out the window?
First, look out the window and see what's below it.
Then figure out how tall it is. You may have to take damage.
I fail. Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna jump out the window.
No, you're not gonna just jump out the window. Moving on, what else is in the desk?
A data slab, did you get that?
Yeah.
Mark it down as a color to help you remember that there's a green band on it.
Data slab, green band.
That way it's just to help identify it from others. Also, as you continue rifling through the desk, you find a couple of shells for a shotgun.
What kind? Are they normal, or do I have to check later?
I'll check later. Alright, and...
What do I get from these corpses?
Well, we'll resolve one loot issue at the time.
Ah, okay. Sorry.
Yes.
Loot return. Yeah.
There's not much else besides random collections of notes that are essentially ledgers.
I'll grab those anyways.
Also, okay. Try and grab any medicinal drugs.
They're all medicinal one way or another.
Well, yeah,
I'm going to take,
grab them all
and decide what to do with it later.
Utilize to beneficial effects.
As you start taking all of his notes out of the desk, you notice a vox caster.
Ooh. That's handy. I'm grabbing that.
Other than that, you notice nothing else that would be rendered useful to you.
Okay, is there anything in the room that we can use to tie up the two survivors?
They're both wearing belts.
Okay, yeah, I'm gonna do that, wrap their wrists up, et cetera, stuff their, tear up their shirt and stuff the shirt in the mouth so they're gagged. Anything on did anything survive this guy?
I didn't see a ping if you did ping it.
This guy.
He's
this guy? His charge pack and his weapon have been basically rendered into black husk.
Alright, so there's nothing there. Okay, I'm going to grab this guy and drag
him. Sorry, I did forget to mention, on this guy here, the only thing that did survive was a fire cultist. Oops. That was my bad. One throne guilt.
Yay.
As for the guy you're also standing over, Tiber, you also find one throne guilt.
The minimum wage will be just going extremely low.
That's all that survived. The rest melted.
We did kind of incinerate both of them.
Yeah. Okay.
Let's try.
What Scythia get?
Okay, you want to go over Scythia's loot? Mm-hmm. No, also, I assume he also searched the fat man for loot?
Yeah.
You find a couple of rings, one silver, one iron, a small chem-testing auger, an Obscura injector.
Hold on, I write slow. Ring iron. So ring silver, ring iron.
Yes.
What was that after?
Chem-testing auger?
Yes.
Chem-testing auger. Okay.
You also find on him 30 Thrum Gilt.
30G.
And also you find one more charge pack for his last pistol.
Did the last pistol come out all right?
His last pistol did come out fine.
Okay.
We should incinerate the guy with the
shotgun. I'll examine the last pistol later.
Yeah, okay. And you also find a couple of rounds for a revolver, and you see a stub revolver also tucked into his belt.
Revolver stub.
The revolver does have a full 8 total, 2 out of the gun, 6 in the gun.
Alrighty. Next. That's everything that I can see.
Oh, and a knife. But it's a cheap knife that's not worth a damn.
I'm gonna just leave it. Okay. So I'm just gonna drag him over to the window here, see what I can see out there.
Yeah, we're just gonna go ahead and assume you're carrying him over your shoulder.
Yeah.
Alright, Scythia. Also, Varnius, on this guy, the one you knocked out, or whoever searched him, you find 2 Thrum Gilt.
Well, they are getting paid very little.
Oh, yeah, also, you find an Obscura injector and a half-charged charge pack.
And his gun.
Yes, and his gun. Mind you, carrying around 30 weapons, I would consider unwieldy.
Charge pack, half charged, and his las gun.
Like I said, I would personally find carrying around too many weapons unruly.
Well, the point is to get them and then sell them.
Yeah, I know. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Do you know that if you guys pick up too many, I will start counting penalties.
Mm-hmm. How many? Are there curtains on the window over here?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to peek out the window and see what's outside.
You see people gathering around the corner outside, but not much else. What you can see, it's pretty clear.
All right.
And looking out, you think you see a crate below the window.
All right.
I have a weapon in line. Can I use that to...
Guardsman, jump out the window, see if it's safe. I'll toss down the fat man to you.
I have a grappling hook.
What do I have to roll for this?
Hmm?
Oh, that's right. Can he use the grapnel to lower the fat man to the ground without killing him?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to do that. But I'm going to tear the curtain down and wrap the fat guy up in it.
Okay.
Let's move on to Scythia's loot resolution.
Scythia, you find the one guy that had the stub revolver.
Okay.
It's intact, and it's missing 3 rounds. Okay. I believe he fired 3 times at you.
Yeah.
You also find in his belt 3 more rounds for the pistol.
Okay.
You find 5 Thrum Gilt. And an Obscura injector on one guy.
How do you spell that?
A-B-S-C-U-R-A.
Did I say A? Why did I say A?
And Victor, right?
Okay. And on the other guy?
On the other guy, you find his lasgun, a full charge pack, and 2 thrown gelt, as well as another Obscura injector.
Okay. So 2 Obscura injectors, a lasgun, full charge pack.
Yep. The charge pack in the lasgun he's currently holding has about 58 shots.
Okay. And there's 58 shots in the one that's currently in the rifle.
Yes. So you could say dump out the charge pack and leave the gun. Or you could take the gun, your choice.
I'm going to take the gun, I think. Probably try and get to using it later.
Yeah, in other words, if your gun list starts extending off of your sheet, then that's when I'm going to consider you guys overburdened.
Mm-hmm. Mine's nearly like that anyway.
Hmm? Well, that's your fault.
Alright, That's about it. That's all you got, all you find on those guys.
Mercutio, grab the living thug.
Mercutio will do so.
Alright, everybody, let's get out of here.
Jump out the window.
Okay, so Kalthus is gonna jump out the window. Let's see what happens.
I'm gonna grapple out the window. Safely.
You're grappling with the fat man. Safely.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, we're gonna move back to the city map.
Where are we going to run to?
Mind you, your window is here. The guards are entering over here. Reinforcers, I should say.
Yeah.
So we're going this way.
Yeah, we are going this way. We're gonna head down through the
There's also this alleyway down here.
Where does that alley lead? Anywhere?
As far as you can tell, it's just a very dark alley.
Alright, we'll get, bloody hell.
We shouldn't loiter in the area, we should just move on to our
We'll get Kalthus to move up towards the hab stack to make sure there's no guards while we run down the alley with our, our prisoners.
Somehow you guys make all of these movements completely unnoticed.
Awesome.
Woo.
Alright, let's get into the hab. What happens when you get into the hab stack?
You throw open the door. It's a grungy
lobby. It's literally an apartment.
So, wait a minute. Can we pause it here?
That's what I imagine a hab stack would be. I could be wrong. But hey, my rule trumps everything. It's a grungy lobby. At the far end, at the end of the room, there's 2 elevators. Mm-hmm. And they're both broken down. There's also a set of stairs.
Can we pause for today?
Can we what?
Pause for the day.
Yes, we can.
Yeah, see, see the quest items like the chem lamp and all that, are you counting that under gear or just items that are...
I just lumped it all under bonus quest gear for me.
Ah.
Okay, chem lamp does not count as quest gear. It was given to you for the quest, but it can be destroyed like anything else.
Okay. We got one of each for that.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, I'm just going to drop my chem lamp, because you can always use torch in some of the
Let's just drop it. We can sell that shit.
Well, I'm
we
over
want you to avoid using any psychic powers whenever possible. You would keep the chem lamp.
Yeah, I know. Oh, I don't want to end up collapsing again.
Collapsing is the least of my concerns.
Yeah.
He'll collapse and get his leg shot off and bleed out.
That wouldn't happen.
So, since I believe some people have things to do, I believe this is an end of an episode.
Awesome.
Well, it is 20 past 12.
So, this has been Operion. I hope to see you guys all next time.
Indeed.
See you.
And until next time, all the best, and I hope you enjoyed. Bye.
Curiosity signing off. Have fun or die trying. But please, try not to die. I can't handle the lawsuits. Bye-bye.
Or summon the Horrors of the Warp.